Stone called me breathless last night. He has talked to two different high-level sources and confirmed that Paul Ryan and Rince Priebus and the establishment are still planning to not just try to steal the nomination or scuttle it at the RNC event coming up in Cleveland, but they're also planning to take all the money. This is amazing. And to not win, but to scuttle it for Hillary, which they openly are bragging about. This is all coming up today. John Kerry calling for borderless world, saying it's coming. The EU saying stay in or you'll have World War III. But right now, let's go to this important report from John Bound.
Heiko Maas, the German Federal Minister of Justice, got an earful of the voice of the German people while speaking at a May Day celebration. The German people chant, "You leftist rat and traitor." Maas says, "No, we're here to stay. We aren't going anywhere." The chants of traitor and get out become stronger and louder. But Maas fires back, threatening, "We will also take care of the interests of those people shouting traitor right now without even knowing what's happening to them." The chants continue as Maas says, "Shout all you want. The longer you shout, the longer I shall stand here." Finally, he leaves the podium as they chant, "Traitor, get out." Leaving the Germans to chant, "We are the people." Heiko Maas, yet another arrogant globalist tool from the Merkel regime. The same man that introduced a 2015 law known as Data Stolen Goods. A law described by Berlin District Court Judge Ulf Burmeier as an anti-whistleblower law intended to deal a mighty blow to democracy and freedom of speech, where in Germany, xenophobia and racism is now a punishable crime. Furthermore, Maas is now calling for a legal ban on sexist advertisements. Germany, well known for its liberal attitude towards adult entertainment, is now being forced to scale back its culture in order to appease the wishes of the growing Muslim refugee population exploding within Germany. Meanwhile, the German people are being held captive by the ungrateful foreign invaders and their own treasonous government.
Die kommen hierher und wir dürfen nicht mehr lang gehen. Junge, 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 du aus Dinger raus hier.
Sohn, so wie der aussieht, als Einzelfall wieder in eine Schublade gepackt wird von 20.000 anderen. Weil so machen die das nämlich. Alles klein halten, nichts in die Öffentlichkeit.
William F. Jasper of the New American writes, "The migration tsunami that swamped Europe with 1.5 million refugees in 2015 is roaring back with a tidal wave that may be double the size of last year's deluge. In fact, most citizens of the European Union countries appear to be unaware that their unelected and unaccountable rulers at the European Commission, in their own European Economic Forecast report issued last fall, announced precisely that. That is, they projected with apparent acceptance and approval that 3 million refugee migrants would arrive in Europe in 2016. Time is running out. The globalists have all but achieved their soft invasion of Europe, and that planned gridlock of civilization is heading in your general direction. As I speak, thousands of unvetted refugees are filing into small towns across the United States via what will be known later as a broken vetting process. A process that should have taken 2 years has now been reduced to a few pointless months. It's Obama's turn, and he aims to match Merkel's numbers.
How do you think the president would explain to Mrs. Merkel about his inability to have that happen here in the United States when Germany's taken in close to, I think, maybe a million people?
Well, again, I think the president, when he travels to Germany, will be prepared to tell her that he's prepared to meet the goal.
That just seems like it might be a little embarrassing to not be able to get 10,000 people into your country.
But Ron, I'm not willing to say that we're not going to hit the goal.
John Bound for Infowars.com.
We'll be back. Stay with us. The United States has been captured by foreign banking cartels openly. The United States was then used as a command base with our energy and our troops and our inventive population to launch the World Government Project. And now we enter the final phases of the open birth of world government, the rollout of world government that's already in place. The skeletal system is there. the muscles, the organs, the vascular system is being added, the skin is being prepared. The Panopticon computer surveillance grids are being fired up, tested. The psychological warfare grids are heating up. We are living in a fantastical time. And what's amazing is so many prominent people call me off the record, heads of newspapers, heads of major news websites, and they say, you know, I worked in the government before, and I worked in intelligence, or I worked in, and everything you're saying is true. It's just unbelievable. What do we do? Well, you pull back and look at how we were put into this trance. And therein you find the answer of how to reverse this. But yesterday, I took a screenshot of it and tweeted it out at Real Alex Jones. It's a screenshot of the Drudge Report yesterday. Kerry declares borderless world. And then below that, there was another article where Cameron basically says a new world war could start, or a war could start if the UK tries to leave the euro. And I tweeted, when Kerry declares borderless world, close quote, he is talking about a corporate world government that can run over the nation state. That's obviously an oversimplification because it's Twitter, so I had a limited number of letters to use. But that's what it is. And the same arrogance of a Cameron saying, you better do this or we'll be destabilized into war. You better let these unelected foreign boards make all our laws and run everything in secret or we're not going to be safe. That's terrorism. And when you've got open world government being announced, and college students being told by Obama this weekend and by Kerry, that's the new talking point, that you're going to live in a borderless world. It's going to be very challenging, very confusing. Yeah, because you'll have nation states that are communist, nation states that are fascist, administered and run by multinational combines who are above the law. That's what Obama, a month and a half ago, went to Argentina, or a month ago, and told him. He said, oh, we're merging the two. Internationally, you need free trade, but then the nation state can be communist, where they call it communism, and you're a slave to the globalist. Here's a headline of Bloomberg. Catastrophe is the new normal for Venezuelans. And guess who's completely in debt to the IMF and World Bank by design, and who the IMF and World Bank would rather work with is communist. Communists have been the clients of the globalist bank system since the Bolsheviks were financed by the House of Rothschild and by J.P. Morgan Chase and others in 1917. And you've got all these ignorant pseudo-intellectuals running around with their Bernie Sanders shirts on. I went and picked up some tacos for the family Sunday morning at a taco deli, the name of the place, pretty good tacos. And there were like five people wearing Bernie shirts. The place was completely standing room only. I was getting food to go. Sat there 15 minutes waiting, and I had no less than three of the people wearing Bernie shirts that were running the orders out to people. It was like 100 people in there or more, just standing up waiting to get their food. It's so popular on a Sunday morning. They're like, hey, I really appreciate your work, Alex. Hey, keep up the good work. And they were wearing Bernie shirts. And I get he's the populist socialist, and he's cute, and he's anti-banker, and, you know, why should the Walmart family have $300 billion and all the rest of it. But they play that class envy, and it's so dumbed down and simplistic that they sit here in a country where you can have thousands of choices and millions of different opportunities when it comes to where you want to work or where you want to live or what you want to buy or what lifestyle. I mean, you've got so many choices, and these spoiled brats sit here in this TV generation liking the idea that Bernie Sanders is going to give them something free. Let me explain something to everyone, and I know our audience knows this, but we have new viewers every millisecond, new listeners every millisecond. The ultra-rich are funding collectivism because they're exempt from it and offshore. They create centralized, top-down, regulated, command-and-control, crony capitalist economies. And because production is so high, we can still all have the baubles and the symbols of success that the media tells us we need. But culturally, and when it comes to savings and so many other ways, we are completely impoverished. When it comes to knowing how to plant a garden, or knowing how to climb a tree and pick fruit, or how to fix an engine, or how to mend a broken leg, we don't have any of our frontier smarts that made the United States so special. We are completely domesticated. I mean, I see these articles every day. London Telegraph, parents, smartphones harming children's ability to hold conversations, say teachers. Well, I mean, we know it causes brain damage. We know it causes rewiring of the brain. We know it limits vocabulary. We know it's hurting us, but we just can't help it because the kids are already addicted. We're addicted on our smartphone. We throw them a smartphone, and then none of us even talk when we're at dinner at night. Isn't that where this is going? And we're one step away from Zuckerberg walking openly, bipedally, with everyone else squatting like gorillas, wearing their virtual reality goggles that he programs the reality for. It's beyond the wizard's curtain. You put a curtain over your head and then live in this tiny false reality, which they admit is their plan. And here's where I'm going with all this. I don't take any pleasure, quite frankly, when I get calls from some of the biggest media people in the United States. And they're all nervous and they want to talk off air and that they want this to be off record. And they sit there and think they're having some big solidarity with me when they're going, I guess you're right about the government working with radical Islam. And I guess you're right about them shipping drugs in. And I guess you're right about the media control and about infiltrators and about all this. And how bad is it going to get? And I talk to people all the time and I'm sitting there going, look, you should have been awake a decade ago, 20 years ago. Everybody warned the public about this. This stuff is all in international trade agreements. We're going into world government. And the fact that I'm so cutting edge talking about this shows the trance people are in. Because I'm just discussing what is admitted open fact. The Pope has called for world government. We know the nature of the world government is a private corporate banking cartel with SDR, strategic drawing rights, new digital currency that all other currencies will be based on in QE Unlimited, basically, which then gives these central banks total absolute control. You think the old fractional reserve banking, where they'd have $10 in the bank and loan out $100, gave the central banks power? You think it gave them power to take one mortgage and sell it 20, 30, 40, 50, sometimes 100 plus times, and leverage $100,000 into a billion? They've just got giant piles of monopoly digital garbage that they created, that they got governments to sign on to by holding us hostage in 2008. And now they're announcing world government with all these carbon taxes and wellhead taxes and other energy taxes and digital money transfer taxes. That's why they want to get rid of cash now. They're moving us into their plan. Their plan's public. A world cashless society where you'll be social engineered according to your choices, controlling what you buy, sell, and do, and where the greatest crime anywhere will be underground economy. Remember the headline a few years ago, $15 million fine for garage sale, Fox News. It actually said, on the second offense, you're caught selling something at a garage sale without it going through some federal inventory, you will be given a $15 million fine. And you're like, well, that'll never happen. Oh, yes, it will. This is total control. And it shows the arrogance of all these different global partnerships chaired by the very same handful of men and women, owned by the very same corporations, merging us into world government, that Kerry comes out and says, we're getting rid of borders, there will be no borders at a commencement speech. I have the clip coming up. And then Cameron comes out and says, you'll destabilize everything. You know, we'll go into war if the UK tries to leave the euro, which, again, they never voted to enter it, neither did Germany or France. They can't vote to get out of it. The polls all show that they would leave it. It's like 80% in Europe. I don't believe these polls are just 50-something percent wanting out in England. And it's the very same arrogance here where Paul Ryan, this is coming up with Roger Stone just in about 15 minutes. This is exclusive. It's up on InfoWars.com, red linked. Paul Ryan and Rince Priebus, who used to work for Ryan, are saying they're going to just keep all the RNC money, all the money that gets donated goes to them, be divvied up, instead of to Donald Trump. So he can't even raise money. And they admit they're preparing to scuttle Donald Trump and give it to Hillary. Just because, you know, he has a cute little trendy beard, little blue eyes, and Priebus looks like a little sock puppet or something. Just these arrogant guys. They've stolen the country. They think it's legitimately theirs. All right, let's get back into the news. Head of Roger Stone joining us with probably the biggest Trump news we've ever announced here.
We'll stand up.
In the next segment.
At the terror in each sip and in each sup.
So many times in history, populations take the arrogance of the elite and their confidence as invincibility. But the type of grasping, bootlicking, sycophantic people like Paul Ryan and Rince Priebus and the rest of them that rise to the tops of these organizations, not because they're good leaders or independent men, but because they're total minions who get off on the security of going into their big marble buildings and into their back rooms and sitting around with a lobbyist and the representatives from the establishment thinking they're invincible. That's criminology. That the more criminals get away with something, the more reckless they get. Just like they tried to announce, there was never voting in a primary. You silly conspiracy theorist. They actually use those terms. Conspiracy theorists and kooks think that your vote counts and the delegates supposedly pledge themselves. Well, they do. And I don't care if you change some rule to say it, then we need to change that back where you claim the inner party decides who can run for president directly out of the communist Politburo Central Committee system. I mean, that's what it is. And these lawyers, they all get up there in their $3,000, $4,000 suits and they sit there with their $500 ties on and their $4,000 shoes. And they think because they're banging hookers every night on taxpayer expense and, you know, eating $200 steaks and fly around in helicopters, that that means they're infallible and invincible. I'm always reading about billionaires and people, like one of the Walmart heirs, the guy was worth like $80 billion. He went and got super dangerous ultralight and crashed it and killed himself. And family said, well, he thought he was invincible because he had $80 billion. No, you're not invincible. That's what I'm getting at here, is these people are crazy. What do they call small planes and small jet planes? They call them doctor killers. Because so many doctors and lawyers go get their license, they learn to fly, they get arrogant, they get confident, and then they drive their planes right into the ground. It's that same delusion, that megalomania. As they get more power, they feel more and more invincible. And so they came out and said, nobody can have Trump, and all these foreign leaders agree, and so we're going to just take it away from him. People said, no, you're not. So it caused the numbers to get even stronger for Trump, so now they've backed off. And I said last week with Stone, I said, you watch. They're arrogant. They're not going to back off now. They think they're invincible. They're just waiting so that Trump stops talking about how they're stealing it from him, and then they're going to basically scuttle it or take the money or do something. And that's exactly what they're doing, is they're claiming because the RNC, the money goes to the RNC first, it's a clearinghouse, that they're going to keep the money and that Trump's supposed to make a deal with them. And then they're going to basically run the ship aground and let Hillary get in, which Paul Ryan has said and Mitch McConnell have said. Again, the arrogance level that they get up there and say, we're the party, we run this country, we'll do what we want, we're working with Hillary. They've totally uncloaked themselves. Just like John Kerry comes out and Obama in the same weekend at commencement speeches and says, we're going to have a borderless world, get used to it. Just like they say, hey, UK, you got to stay in the European Union, even though you never got to vote 20 years ago to enter it, and even though it now makes almost all your laws and is ordering the UK to bring in hundreds of thousands every few months of unvetted people from Syria and other areas, or they're going to fine them €250,000 per person. Unelected bureaucracy says €250,000 for each person you refuse. And you're a nation state. And you go, I don't want to pay for this. I don't want to do this. They go, that's the way it is. You're going to go under it. That's world government. It's not just like they're building some Star Trek federation. We're all going to be lovey-dovey and, you know, walk around in, you know, cool one-piece outfits and fly around and battle the aliens and whatever. That's all UN programming. The UN symbol, they admit that. The symbol of the Starfleet and all the rest of it. It's just in your face. No, it's big, giant megabanks above the law and armored fortresses controlling everything we do and dictating what we do. And then you look at the media and the propaganda, the culture they're pushing is pure death, anti-family, anti-free market, eugenics. These people are pure evil. They're committed to evil. John Kerry is telling students at commencement speeches that's coming up that we're in a borderless world and sovereignty is gone. This is 21st century warfare we're witnessing, and that's why Donald J. Trump is under such attack, because he is a nationalist. He said globalism is the problem. It's not fair. It's a bunch of special interests screwing over the nation state. They've used America's openness to come in and buy us off. It wasn't the communists that were the big threat, say, in Russia. It was the globalists within using collectivism to domesticate our people. So it was the sneak attack. We're going to Roger Stone with probably the biggest news he's ever broken here. I keep saying that each week when he comes on because it just gets bigger and bigger, but this is huge. The story's up on Infowars.com. It is an exclusive. It's red-linked. It needs to go viral everywhere. Roger Stone, Ryan, and Priebus planning to extort Trump at RNC. Now, are they looking to openly take over the money? Yes. Are they looking to scuttle the campaign for Hillary? They've admitted that. He needs to be removed as speaker now. The arrogance is just dumbfounding. They're like villains out of a Shakespeare play. We're going to Mr. Stone here in just a moment of StoneZone.com. Before I go any further, we've had a storable food special that ran for 2 weeks. It was only supposed to run a week. It was 30 to 40% off. It was the most successful sale we ever did, because people realize the climate's crazy with all the destabilization. And I don't like to end a special when it's doing so well, and that helps the small profit we make on each sale overall with a lot of sales helps fund the operation. I'm a free market guy. It's the highest quality, lowest price, smaller profit per unit, but sell more units. Win, win, win. But because we go with My Patriot Supply, probably the best company out there, I know for the price they're excellent. The packaging's amazing. It's fresh. They said, look, we have contracts. You're a private labeler, so in our full spectrum of foods, so you can offer these discounts sometimes, but we gotten too much heat from other suppliers and people. You're undercutting the market. You got to stop. And I said, okay, what about this? On our four top selling packages, how about I just say 40% off just on those? And they went and checked and looked, and they said, yeah, if it's not on the 60-something packages that are there, sure. So that hasn't even been launched yet, but that's going to be up on the site by later today. On the four-week, on the six-month, on the year, and on another package, you can select which, you know, what's in them and customize them some as well. We're going to offer that not just 30% off, but 40% off on those specific packages. So I can't do it on everything, but I can do it on those four packages that's being prepared right now. Infowarsstore.com. Also, this ends tonight, and it will end tonight. 10% off all preparedness products, from shortwave radios and non-GMO heirloom seeds to the entire InfoWars Life formulas and more at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com. That is going on. And your purchases make everything we do here possible, obviously. Now, separately, censorship. I've got articles, mainstream articles, admitting Facebook is censoring libertarians and conservatives and Donald Trump. We already knew that. We could see it. But now it's admitted. It's even in Gizmodo, you know, establishment publications. Former Facebook workers, we routinely suppress conservative news. Absolutely. That just means alternative news, folks. Roger Stone has been banned on CNN, on MSNBC, openly, because he's so effective, because he's so accurate. That's why you all should sign up for the free newsletters. We can underground get you stuff as things get censored more. Infowars.com/newsletter. That's why you should go to StoneZone.com and you know, sign up for his email alerts and everybody else in the Liberty Movement so we can stay in contact with each other. Now, let's just stop right there. Roger Stone joins us with undoubtedly the biggest news since he first started coming on the broadcast 11 months ago. Warning of the plan to steal the convention in a broker convention. At first he got poo-pooed for that, then it all came out it was true. A month before it was admitted that the Koch brothers were meeting in secret with other billionaires to donate hundreds of millions to try to defeat Trump, He broke that. They denied it the next day. Turned out a month later, that meeting actually happened. That was even in the New York Times. So just over and over again, he gives us the inside baseball. And that's why they call him dirty and evil and mean, because they're dirty and evil and mean. And because he tells the truth, they're scared of him. Former campaign head for Trump. Well, he has two sources. That was as of last night. I know he's been working on it more. It's up on Infowars.com. He's just been in New York the last few days meeting with Trump and the rest of the campaign team, unofficially, but wargaming with him. So he's got a lot to cover with us today. Roger Stone, Ryan and Priebus planning to extort Trump at RNC. GOP establishment still scheming to steal the nomination from the populist New York frontrunner. And it goes over all this. He's got the internal plan that they were going to use with Cruz. So he's going to break it all down for you to the end of this hour, the next 22 minutes. I want to thank Roger Stone for joining us. Thank you for giving us this exclusive, Roger.
Alex, as always, I'm delighted to be with you. It is, first, let's kind of set the table. The mainstream media this weekend, as we have seen, seems to be focused on the past. Point here is not one of party unity, but one of recognizing that the millions of people that Trump is bringing to the Republican banner, or at least to his candidacy, more than offset the 5% who are never Trump. So the focus is entirely wrong, understandably, because Trump is the first political figure really in decades who's been able to expand the Republican base and change the entire dynamics of the next election.
And I love how he said, look, I'm a populist. I'm a conservative, but it's Republican Party, not conservative party. Plus, Paul Ryan, these people are not conservative leaders. They're globalist puppets who openly say they'd rather have Hillary. He should be removed as the Speaker of the House right now for that alone. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Roger.
Well, at a minimum, he should be removed as chairman of the Republican National Convention.
And hired by Hillary. He should be the head of her campaign.
Well, if he cannot support the democratically selected nominee of his party, he should step down. But the point here, I think, is that instead of focusing on quote-unquote party unity, Trump yesterday said correctly, the party may not be unified. Let me be clear. This movement and Trump's candidacy is much bigger than the Republican Party. That is the point that they missed. Now, Alex, we only lost the last presidential election by 700,000 votes distributed in five states. If you went to Colorado, Iowa, Florida, Michigan, Nevada, New Jersey, Ohio, Virginia, Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania, there are at least 1 million people who are unregistered but meet the profile of Trump supporters. Politics is about addition, not subtraction. I mean, I had to laugh this weekend because, as you've seen, Bush 41, Bush 43 say they won't support the nominee.
Thank God.
The mainstream press thinks this is a negative. This is a positive. George W. Bush destroyed our economy and sent American men and women to fight and die in a war where we had no vital national interest. He is a disgraced foreign president.
And bare minimum covered up the Saudi Arabian role.
At a minimum. So the idea that you can't win without the support of George W. Bush or his father, who is another criminal, it's a false narrative. Then this is even more laughable. Jeb Bush comes out and says he can't support Trump because Trump doesn't have the character to be president. Let me get this straight. Jeb Bush, who was a drug dealer in boarding school and college in his early years in Houston and Miami, Jeb Bush, who defrauded a Florida SNL out of $4 million paid for by the taxpayers, Jeb Bush, who lined his pockets in return for official acts he took as governor of Florida, he is saying Donald Trump doesn't have the integrity to be president.
Yeah, a guy that never got above 5 points or whatever. I mean, it just shows the delusion. It's like we live in North Korea or something with them propping these people up and the arrogance of these folks. So this is where we are now. I want to get into, you know,
Let's get into the big meeting that's coming up. Paul Ryan is posturing, making his support for Donald Trump conditional on a set of demands. Those demands need to be
now,
seen.
Now, stop for a moment because the sirens in the background. Roger Stone, this is a big deal. I mean, you just dropped such bombshells. I want folks to listen carefully. You have this from inside the RNC. You know, tell folks, kind of walk through what you can repeat to the audience that you told me last night of the magnitude of their arrogance and that they still think they're going to, bare minimum, rob the money of everybody that donates to Trump and scuttle this for Hillary. I mean, you know, phrase this as you did last night to me, please.
Certainly shall. First of all, it's important to understand the history. RNC Chairman Reince Priebus is often publicly identified with Romney or with his governor in Wisconsin, Walker. But in truth, Reince Priebus is a Ryan man. That's his birthright in politics, Paul Ryan. Don't forget that as we move forward. So in essence, Ryan is going to demand of Trump is control of the Republican National Committee would remain in the hands of Priebus and his cohorts. They would also demand that the Trump campaign use the data vault, which was built and is partially owned by Karl Rove, for all of their outgoing voter contact. We happen to know that this system is flawed. It's dirty. It was proven to be ineffective in the 2012 campaign. They've essentially just taken the Romney data program, which crashed on Election Day, and recycled it as a new product. It's still flawed. Beyond that, they want to demand that the individual Republican state chairman have control and run the Trump campaigns in the individual states. Now, this struggle is mostly about money. It's about the favored vendors for Reince Priebus getting multi-millions of dollars worth of business from the Trump campaign and from the 2016 effort. Here's what Reince Priebus doesn't understand. He and Paul Ryan are about to meet the toughest negotiator probably alive today. Speaking as someone who over the last 30 years has negotiated multiple compensation agreements with Donald Trump, I can just tell you, he's tough, he's clear, he's blunt, and he understands that the movement that he is leading is far bigger than the Republican Party. He will not be blackmailed. He will call for Ryan to step down as speaker, as convention chairman. There is, as I reported here on InfoWars last week, a backbench revolt among individual liberty-minded congressmen who are furious with Ryan.
And Sarah Palin is pledging to go after Ryan in his reelection. What a wonderful lady. This is America taking its country back. This is so exciting. And again, it shows their arrogance that they think they can try to steal it, even though it already backfired on them when they tried to publicly sell it. If Paul Ryan said he'd rather have Hillary, and so has the leader of the Senate, Mitch McConnell, on record, then they have no place at the head of the RNC. They have no place as the speaker, no place as the Senate majority leader. I say get on the offense now, and I understand Trump's giving them a chance to back off, and they need to just remove themselves because, look, they'll steal the money, and then they'll scuttle the campaign and give it to Hillary. That's their stinking plan. They've admitted it. These little rat bastards have admitted it. Mr. Stone, am I wrong?
No, you're absolutely right. And, Alex, this is the insidious hand of Karl Rove. Let's remember, Rove has a proprietary interest in the data trust data bank. Rove has tight relationships with many of these Republican state chairmen. So the fix is in if Ryan and Priebus get their way. Now, I also believe that the RNC has a $1 million hard bank debt that the Trump campaign is unaware of. I also think that there are accounting tricks being used at the RNC to make their fundraising totals look more impressive than they are, taking compliance money and legal money and recount money and essentially double counting it to make the bank balances look higher. So this is just my personal view. I would urge Donald Trump and his people to do an audit of the Republican National Convention Committee as soon as he takes control. And I would make no deal to give away what has been, since the 1860s, the right of the Republican national nominee to control the party in an election year.
So really the headline here is from Infowars.com. Paul wrote a very good article, conferring with us last night. But, I mean, really it's a bunch of neocons or a bunch of rhinos are trying to hijack the party and derail the whole process, claiming it's their rules, trying to openly steal the money, trying to take over the process, and try to take control of the party away from the presumptive nominee even after they're nominated. This is just so sensational. But in the age of the TPP secretly being ratified, and we're under world government, and in the age of the Pope calling for world government, and everyone saying Donald Trump's so evil because he says globalism is destroying us, isn't this emblematic of these bureaucrats and these politicians, because they're in control of the system, believing they own it and control it, and then they come out and openly say it's all theirs? I mean, I'm wondering if they realize how this has backfired. They already tried to sell that there's no popular election, one man, one vote doesn't exist in the primary, silly kids, that never happened, even though you have all the public interest and the money and election laws and false advertising and the rest of it. But now they just think they can just take it again and take over the party. That just really shows how delusional these people are. You were there when they tried to steal it from Reagan and force the compromise. You were there throughout this. Have you ever seen such levels of brazen megalomania in your view, Roger Stone?
Let me put it this way, Alex. I have never seen a situation in which a Republican speaker tried to blackmail the Republican nominee for president. This is extortion. And all he has, Paul Ryan, has to trade, of course, is his endorsement, which he has withheld to create this leverage. Let me move on, because there's another important development this weekend. You, I'm sure, noticed that Donald Trump engaged Hillary Clinton on the questions of her husband's epic abuse of women and her role in covering up that scandal.
And let's just say it, you don't like to brag, but you've been advising Trump for a year and a half. This is the game plan. You told me a few weeks ago, watch, get ready, he's going to go after her on this, and he did. Which shows he's got the bona fides to go toe-to-toe. He's for real, folks. This is what we've always needed, is somebody to not play patty cake. Continue, Roger.
Well, look, Donald Trump is his own man, and he decides what he says, but I think it is very clear that he has read my book, The Clinton's War on Women, as have hundreds of thousands of other Americans. So when New York Magazine yesterday reported that Trump made this claim without foundation, no, there's a lot of foundation. Read the book.
Well, we're going to go over it in the books available at InfoWarsStore.com, but let me just add, I see articles every day saying Donald Trump claimed that the Saudis had a role in 9/11, there was a cover-up with no proof, and they don't even mention the 28 pages. So, you know, this is like Gibbs saying there's no drone program 6 years after the program's public. Sorry, go ahead.
Well, but it's very important to understand here what the strategy is, because the Clintonites hope that they can suppress this story as they did in the 80s. Unfortunately for them, that was the pre-internet age. So they have put enormous pressure on CNN, on Fox, on MSNBC, on the networks, trying to claim, oh, this has all been discredited.
No, they admit on MSNBC and CNN, as you know, they cut people's mics when they mention this.
Yeah, it's extraordinary, but it won't work, and I'll tell you why. Because you cannot gag the nominee of the Republican Party.
Can't do it.
You cannot gag Donald Trump, and he gets it. Now, her entire campaign strategy is based on winning a disproportionate number of votes from women. Media Matters for America, the Clinton apologists, financed by Soros, but directed by Hillary, seek to pressure and discredit anyone who raises this question. This is really simple, though. Let Juanita Broderick speak. Let Paula Jones speak. Let my friend Kathleen Willey speak. Hear them out. Let them tell you exactly what happened to them at the hands of Bill and then at the hands of Hillary. Then Hillary can deny it if she wishes.
That's right.
And the American people can decide who's telling the truth. But for her to say, for Hillary to say that young college women who are sexually assaulted at school deserve to be believed, but these women do not deserve to be believed, is outrageous.
Well, now, the truth is they're an organized crime syndicate. They've settled cases. We know they're doing it. And thank God you wrote the book to expose it all. Other facets. I mean, I love the fact that Trump's so strong. I love the fact he's not backing down. I love his foreign policy speech. So much good stuff is happening. What are other pitfalls? What are other attacks? What else is on the radar? I mean, bottom line, I guess we get the word out about the Clintons and their abuse of women. We get the word out about what Paul Ryan and Priebus, these little arrogant creatures, are doing. We expose the fact that the whole world's trying to gang up on us and tell us what to do. What else is on the radar, Roger Stone?
Well, there was one other very significant development this weekend, in which Donald Trump referred to the Clinton Foundation as a scam. So you're seeing the elementary messages of Donald Trump's campaign. He has vowed to go after Hillary, hammer and tong. He understands her epic abuse of women. He understands the disaster that is her tenure as Secretary of State. And he understands the largest single money laundering operation in U.S. history, which is the Clinton Foundation. The mainstream media is trying desperately not to cover these stories as if they don't exist. Terrific piece on Breitbart this week about how subsequent developments regarding the Clinton Foundation got no mainstream media coverage.
Sure.
So we see the game they are going to try to play. They're going to try to make these issues untouchable. This worked for them in the 80s. It is not going to work for them in 2016.
Well, even when I talk to Democrats and people I know, some of them which are prominent here in Austin, they go, no, we can see Trump winning now. We can see it. Hillary's damaged goods. And then the FBI is set to talk to her this week. I mean, even if they don't go after her, it's just this whole backdrop that it's if she's crawling, you know, towards her own grave while trying to crawl away from it at the same time. She wants more power to protect herself into the future. She should just hope for a pardon out of Obama. How was Trump when you met with him in New York? He seems to be energized when I see him out on the campaign trail. I mean, this whole thing just has the smell of destiny.
Well, Alex, as you know, any conversation I have with Donald is proprietary, and I would never reveal what we talked about.
Sure, but I'm asking overall, how's he doing?
But in terms of his mood, he's excited, he's pumped up, he's super confident about his ability to win. He is. He reiterates again in everything he does that he is his own man. He's not going to be controlled by Wall Street. He's not going to be controlled by K Street. He is going to do this his way. And in all honesty, doing it his way has worked extraordinarily well so far. He is bigger than the Republican Party. He's absolutely right. It's not about whether the party is unified. It's about whether the party can attract several million new people.
And that's beautiful, and that's why they're so scared of him. And Democrats out there, if you want prosperity, folks, just bring somebody in who doesn't dislike America and have it out for the West. These globalists in both parties are setting up a world government. They want to parlay American interest into that for themselves and get themselves seats at the new table. It's not their country to sell out. It's not their election to steal. It's not their government. Even if Paul Ryan and Hillary Clinton and all these people think it, we're watching the death of these individuals. They claim the death of the party. The party died a long time ago. It's rising like a phoenix again because of Donald Trump. This is destiny. You said that they tried the mafia thing on him. They've tried that. It didn't go anywhere. What are other attacks you expect now against Donald J. Trump?
Well, you also saw this fraudulent lawsuit filed in Texas where a non-existent woman claiming to be her own attorney, accused Trump falsely of abusing her in the company of Jeffrey Epstein, the convicted pedophile, who ironically is a running buddy of Bill Clinton and whose top people were,
Who you wrote about in your book and who you told me privately Trump was getting ready to go after him with, so they just threw it back on him.
Yeah, so the good news, of course, is that a judge has now dismissed this lawsuit. It's fraudulent. This was an attempt
to
try to neutralize Trump on the issue that they realize is a killer for the Clintons themselves. What was Bill Clinton doing on pedophile island for these private parties? And what did Hillary think he was doing?
Yeah, not there? Paradise Island, but Pedo Island. Wow, yep. Incredible. Roger Stone, amazing. Thank you. I know you're a really busy man for giving the audience such exclusives, but you're a great patriot. Been exposed to the New World Order for more than 16, 17 years, and decades before that, working inside politics. I really feel history happening here. We should all pray for Donald Trump and pray for this country and the world. Thank you so much, sir. StoneZone.com.
Well, I'm now hoping that the Priebus Ryan plan, having been exposed here at InfoWars, will be much harder for them to pull off. They're going into a negotiation with the toughest son of a gun that I have ever met.
Roger, so, I know you've got to go. We've got a 70-second break. I want you to come back just for 3 minutes on the other side, then I've got to go too. But I want you to talk about the process of how this negotiation is going to happen, when it's going to happen, when we're going to know if they've been successful or not. Audience, get the article at InfoWars.com. Get out to everybody. Get it out to everybody. Don't let them steal your country. Arrogant pieces of trash. Back in 70 seconds. The British East India Company, I'm going to talk about it when we come back in the next segment, set up the model of world government we see forming today. The problem is, once world government comes out of the shadows into the open and really tries to carry out its aims, why do these powerful people want world government? It's eugenics. It's playing God. Once they try to actually implement everything and it goes from stealth mode to out in the open mode, that's the beginning of the fall. They've been gearing up the totalitarianism behind the scenes to try to block us when they emerge. But patriots for 50 years have been exposing them. Back in the days of Barry Goldwater, when people like Roger Stone were first getting involved. So in the last few minutes with Roger Stone, he's breaking down just some incredible things that are happening. We're forcing the Clintons to come out in the open. We're forcing the Paul Ryans to come out in the open. We're forcing them to be arrogant and tell us we don't have any rights and we don't have elections and they'll take all the RNC money and not give it to Donald Trump, because that's where your donations go through them. And they're just showing everyone how delusional they are. It's like you've been out of town for a month, you come back and your arrogant employee trying to stage some type of takeover to your business. You just say, hey, watch this, you're all fired. They just can't believe that they took your kindness for weakness. We got 3 minutes left. I appreciate Roger Stone being here with us. Roger, encapsulate how this is going to play out, when we'll know whether they're successful or not, stealing this, extorting Donald Trump, when these meetings should happen, and what we can do to make sure. Because they didn't want Trump or you talking about how they were stealing the elections and calling him sore loser, but that's what destroyed them, because they were stealing it. So now we're going to continue to attack them and hopefully get the grassroots behind it. So, Roger, what do we do, and how does this play out?
Well, first of all, no one extorts Donald Trump. So that's not going to work. And I think Ryan may misunderstand the value of his endorsement. Trump got nominated without any endorsements other than the great patriot Jeff Sessions. He is not the candidate of endorsements. And I continue to argue that the support of the Romneys and the Bushes is not a positive, it's a negative.
Now, he should come out and say that, not just say, hey, I don't need the party leadership. You know, the party's the people. That's great. He's saying that. Say, hey, I'm glad I don't have you people that sold us out. You're the failures. You're the losers. Sorry, go ahead.
But I can also report that in a closed door meeting of the Republican Lawyers Association last night, there was a presentation by Don McGahn, the lawyer who represents Donald Trump, a very able man, very solid guy, very positive, upbeat presentation about how the campaign is gearing up to raise the money necessary to fund a general election. After Mr. McGahn left, however, the entire meeting focused on a discussion of how to stop Donald Trump in the Rules Committee. Now, the details, all of the details of this closed-door meeting will be up on InfoWars.com tomorrow with a full report, because fortunately, I had a spy in the room.
Just like you did at the Koch brothers meeting, incredible. But just finishing up, when do these negotiations happen? When will we know whether they're going to be successful stealing the war chest?
Donald Trump is going to be meeting with Speaker Ryan and Chairman Priebus on Thursday in Washington, D.C., and we'll see how this gets worked out. But anyone who thinks you can hold up Donald Trump is a fool. He is bigger than the Republican Party. He's the only one with the potential to expand the Republican Party. And Alex, this final thought, those congressmen and those senators who are fleeing Trump today are the same people who will be desperate to get on the platform with him this October. Mark my words.
Absolutely. I mean, they're all the yes men that got there because they're yes men. Trump is independent, clearly. And they're all just a bunch of delusional followers, because just because J.P. Morgan and Goldman Sachs tell them, you know, do this, we're backing you. It's just all a con game, and it's coming down. And regardless, Donald Trump's injecting nationalist issues and anti-politically correct issues that are a godsend. He's a total winner. He's already won by being in the arena, and you're in the arena too. Roger Stone, thank you so much for the time. StoneZone.com. Find both his books on the Clintons and the Bushes at InfoWarsStore.com. Thank you so much, sir.
Great to be here, Alex.
Thank you for all these exclusives. Wow. But it's because he knows you take action as listeners. We're all in this together to defend this republic. The story's up on InfoWars.com. Get it out. And then tomorrow, the one on the big lawyer meeting. Stay with us. We'll be back. A collection of megabanks have seized control of the globe to a great extent. They're mopping up the last corners of resistance. And even drilling down to end all resistance and terminating the life force itself, terminating the will to live and survive and thrive, attacking the very biological processes of humans, and targeting the family unit itself, the basis of civilization. And that is being done openly because they're going to collapse world civilization selectively into a new dark age, and out of that will be the rise of the machines and the technotronic era. Now, you see this in a lot of globalist propaganda placement in fiction, prepping your mind with predictive programming so that you simply accept it into the future. And that is the plan for the planet. I think people should be concerned about an unelected world government being set up whose goal is to carry out eugenics. And I talked earlier about the British East India Company, and it became merged with the Dutch East India Company. These were big private combines backed by banks and insurance companies. And the first stock exchanges, where you'd buy stock in a ship. That way, if you lost a ship, you wouldn't lose everything, because you and 100 other people were invested in it. And they brought in mercenaries. They brought in private groups. They learned how to play groups off against each other in India and other areas. And this is the model we're under today. And you've got all these politicians bought and paid for by globalists, parlaying the national sovereignty, the jobs, the industry, selling it off, even though it's not theirs to sell, to these institutions. And our children are being prepped to go to colleges, to get into debt, and they'll never get jobs, almost all of them, with the degrees they're getting that are obsolete before they even get the degrees. It's all done by design to arrest development and to create servile, soft people ready to be basically taken over with national health care and very slowly euthanized. And here's an article, Politico. Obama will push transgender gender identity rules on all K through 12 schools, kindergarten through 12. And that's in Breitbart. Well, that's already going on. Confusing children, sexualizing children. Who needs Bill Clinton's pedophile island when you've got just the schools becoming places where the school tells your child they can have an abortion, where the school tells your child they can have an inoculation, where the school is going to talk to your five-year-old? I mean, my children are 13, 11, and 8, and I barely have talked to them about sex. And I probably should do it more, but it's an uncomfortable thing. Instead, you've got the government involved trying to confuse their identities. Imagine if somebody wrote a science fiction book 60 years ago, where in the year 2016, they'd be opening the borders to jihadis by the millions. They'd be teaching children how to do things sexually that I didn't even know about till I covered it as a young man on the air. They set up in middle schools. Now they're going to go earlier grades. Little signs up and say, come to this counselor's office, come to this school room after school today if you're bi or curious and if you don't want to be bullied because you're gay. And you get there and then you're led by adults who take you to these off-school retreats that your liberal parents sign on for you to go to. And they go and then they are in dormitories with beds. This has been in the news all over the country. Same program. And then they sit there and teach them all this incredible sexual stuff. And then the teachers say, we're leaving now. Enjoy yourselves. This is pedophilia. With sixth and seventh graders, now they're going to go down lower. It's a sex cult. But the sex cult is only one engineered system to totally confuse and break down society. And they sell it like, oh, you're against somebody because they're, quote, gay. Look, there are homosexual pedophiles. There are heterosexual pedophiles. Anybody trying to sexualize children is a pervert and is encroaching and getting involved in parents' lives and children's lives. They're bullying us. Just like the Republicans bully us and get up there with arrogance and laugh at us on every TV channel going, your vote never counted. It never did. We're sovereign. We decide. We don't go with a mere plurality of the majority. We decide. Okay? I'm George Will, and I approve this message. I'm Curly Hewlin. I approve this message. I'm Revis Previs Weavis. I approve this message. I'm Paul Blue-Eyed, you know, Ryan, boy toy of the house. I mean, it's a bunch of guys up there, literally delusional in their own world, hanging out at the D.C. bathhouses, just thinking they're invincible because they prance around in fancy suits. Look, this country and this planet and our families and this species doesn't belong to you just because you hijacked the country, signed the world onto a bunch of derivatives fraud, and think you own us. It's over. At the bottom of the hour, I'm going to play part of this beautiful classical music that a Russian orchestra played for solidarity with the folks being massacred in Palmyra, Syria. And mainstream Western news decried the Russian propaganda because they had a symphony in solidarity with the people being murdered in the non-radical Muslim nation of Syria. They call that propaganda. Not sending in hundreds of thousands of jihadis, not spending tens of billions of dollars. No, they hate the fact that the Russian orchestra would go to Palmyra in the ruins, recently retaken from ISIS, and they would play there, obviously at serious risk to their lives. And just an act of dignity and wholesomeness. And you know why the New World Order hates classical music? Because it touches the soul. It raises the connections in the brain. It takes us to a higher level. The globalists admit ugly music, ugly culture, ugly this. Every message you see is father is stupid, father is bad, women are all the heroes, women get everything done. It's not to empower women. It's to totally make women disdain men and think that they get power out of dominating men. There are Roman handbooks. You can look them up. We've covered them on how when they would take over areas of Europe, they would bring back slaves. They'd kill the men, but keep boys. And then they would single out as soon as they got to the camp, some of the boys, and beat them with an inch of their life, claiming they'd done something wrong. And they'd tell the women, you suppress your boys, you control them, you spy on them, you report to us, or we're going to kill them. And within just a few months, the women were the biggest oppressors of the men and then set themselves up as a predatory group in every slave culture. The women are the controllers of the men. It's an inverted system. And this is what they've set up. This is what they're doing. And then women are totally frustrated. They've got these men groveling to them. They're in discord in their families. The men act like arrested development babies. And now the wife or the girlfriend's like their mom. And the boys run off together and act like bad kids playing hooky from school. They've taken real women from us. Mother's Day, I had my 90-year-old grandmother over. She's still there when she's there. Sometimes she drifts out. Really smart lady, great lady, classy lady. But my dad's mom, I wish she was still alive. She's been dead 11 years. She was just so smart. And was a real intellectual and was cool. And she loved the men in her family. She loved her husband. She loved my dad and his brother. She loved me. And I just don't see any women like that anymore. They just, where are they? I remember being a little kid, a teenager, and like all those, that last generation of women and the ones before them, I mean, those were just powerful, magical creatures. And now you look at women, they are just freaked out and running scared. And they should be. Our civilization, everything humans built together, everything we did, huddled in the dark, going through the ages, all of the fights we went through together, they've convinced us that we're even separate. We are the species. We are one. You know, first they deny they were building a world government. Now they admit they're doing it. And then the question is, did we vote for that? Did we support that? No. And then, hey, what type of world government is it? No one's asking. What do they want to do? They want to suck all the resources out of us, play us off against each other, and set up hardened facilities worldwide to carry out a mass extermination. And they're going to total automation and robot control as fast as they can so nobody can say no to them. And so the soldiers won't refuse their orders because they're robots. They've already got all of our houses wired with AI, tracking everything we do. They admit they're doing it. I mean, I tell people, and I'm not happy about this. I tell people 18 years ago, they're tracking you with your cable boxes and your smart meters, and it dials into everything because it was public. But it was in the congressional documents. It wasn't widely known. And people would say, you're crazy. Even when I had the documents and wrote articles about it and made films. And now they just go, guess what? Everything's watched. We're tracking everything. And yes, the borders are wide open. But we're going to grope you when you go to the TSA. It's diabolical. It's bad people. Not because they're elites that they get into control, but because they're willing to do anything. They don't have governors. They're like cells malfunctioning and replicating. It's cancer. The globalists are cancer. What else would come in and try to turn the life force off? What else would come in and try to destroy the human family and dumb everybody down? I'm going to come back and play these clips of the Kerry talking about borderless world and the Prime Minister of England saying we could have a new war if you leave the euro. I mean, this is pure terrorism being executed against us. I'm going to open the phones up in the next segment. We're going to have Leanne McAdoo and Joe Biggs coming in the last 30 minutes of the third hour to break down really amazing news. Folks always say there wouldn't be the capacity of elites to carry out really big crimes and cover them up because people go public. Well, we've had hundreds of members of the military, defense intelligence, army intelligence, naval intelligence, FBI. As much as I want to criticize the FBI, they do a lot of bad things at the top. It was the FBI tried to stop 9/11 and spoke out, and a whole bunch of agents got demoted instead of getting awarded. It was even ATF people that started blowing the whistle on Fast and Furious. There are still good people. But we've got all these Facebook insiders coming out and saying, no, we sit there with algorithms and we censor and we put in the pre-programmed things to block folks. I mean, I know I put Donald Trump in a headline on a Facebook mentions and they don't allow it to be shared off our page. I mean, I'm watching it in real time. And then sure enough, the people go public and they say that's exactly what's happening. You go, well, then why are you on Facebook? Because that's where the people are. It's a war. It's like asking if I was in a war, why would I fly over and drop leaflets to the resistance saying, good job? They don't want us in there. We're going to be in there. You don't take the fact they're trying to censor you and play games as a reason to quit. Oh my gosh, I'm running into opposition. Let me quit. No. I go towards the opposition. It's my radar system. That's what I do. I go to the flak. They didn't have satellites back in World War II, folks. And when they'd fly in over Germany or they'd fly in over Japan, they would go to the flak. They'd fly into the clouds of raining metal and explosions. Because that's where the enemy was. But I always hear the general public go, you're going to get opposition. They're going to come after you. They could do something. They could kill you. People tell me that? Really? I've only probably had 15 guests they killed after they came on. Really? They could get me? The death threats I've gone through, the physical attacks, I don't say bring it on because I don't want to have more stuff to deal with. But once it happens, I'm absolutely heading the game because this is what I expect. It's like telling, you know, my dad's dad when he was climbing into a B-17 to flying out of North Africa and bomb Italy. Oh, you know, they're going to be shooting at you when you get there as he's climbing into the cockpit. But that's what they've taught culture. Just deny stuff's going on. Just, conspiracy theorists say that there's a world government. Conspiracy theorists say they're going to sign us on to derivatives. It's just a little excuse for people who don't want to spend time or energy on being involved, who just want to go play golf or go get their Porsche waxed. Or don't you understand you've been given all that to fool you and to make you think you're successful when real manhood and real honor is waiting for you? You only have all this success and all this luxury and all these choices because we had ancestors that would fight to the death before they would bow down to be slaves. And then they looked at themselves and said, we're hypocrites. We just fought to not be slaves to England, and we have slaves. We're hypocrites. That's what Thomas Jefferson wrote. But it was the thought that counted that led to what's happened now. And the whole system opposes that Renaissance idea coming to full bloom. A pro-human, free choice, dynamic, trailblazing adventure. The opposite of the nanny state. The universe is waiting for us. And I love future progeny that don't even exist yet. I guarantee if I could meet my great-great-granddaughter or great-great-grandson, that's my goal, is that they be able to exist. Not in some utopia, but in the true utopia of imperfection and of the challenges of the universe and discovery. The true utopia of the fact that there is no utopia. I love them. I know my ancestors loved me before I was ever born. They had a sense of destiny and living on. And I'm not going to let them down, my ancestors. I love them. I feel them. I have their wisdom. God gave us our ancestors, and God gave us the genetic link to them. So you need to use the tools God gave you and realize that this is the great contest, the great movement to try to harness humanity, to try to make us slaves and mount our head on the wall by these ugly psychopaths that tell us we're obsolete. Ugh. I understand that people don't want to hear they've been conquered by foreign multinational interests, but we have been. And if you ever wondered what it would look like to see the fall of the United States, this is it. I liken it to a 40-foot boa constrictor trying to swallow a small cow. And it's trying to force us down its throat right now, and we're still alive. We can still kick and probably get free, but we have to realize we're in the clutches of a big old mean snake. Some amazing videos on YouTube of like 30, 40-foot snakes eating alligators and stuff. I mean, just crazy. And that's how I would liken it to what's happening now. You see snakes eating something where, let's say, the snake's a foot around, and then they've got something in it that's 3 feet around, and the snake's just lying there with this giant, you know, pig or whatever it's eating inside of it. And it's so greedy, it thinks it can eat it, and the video shows it later throwing it back up because it's too big. And you're like, how did that happen? The snake's jaws come unhinged, and out comes this big monstrosity. That's what it's like watching Paul Ryan say, I'd rather Hillary get elected, and I'm going to try to take the money away from Trump. It's just total arrogance. Like, who died and made you king? Another one of these so-called frat boys that thinks he's smarter and better looking than everybody. All I see is a little boy, a sellout, a nobody, a punk, piece of crap. But he's arrogant, and he's got the right suit, and he's got the right haircut, and he acts confident, so a bunch of idiots out there following. But not anymore. Who cares if the Republican Party leadership says they're not backing Trump? That's a good thing for Trump. And forget Trump. He's a litmus test for how awake people are. Very powerful article up on Infowars.com that just went live. It's amazing. In fact, there's video, guys. I forgot to tell you during the break. Grab it for me. This is so important. This is what I'm finding. When they tried to steal the election from Trump in 8 different states and gave it to Ted Cruz, a lot of Democrats I know who are friends of mine who really like me, you know, because obviously I used to criticize Bush because he was a bad guy as well. Just Obama's like 5 times worse, if that's possible. He is. And they're now going, yeah, I kind of like Trump. Yeah, I kind of get it. He's not really racist. He didn't really do anything. Yeah, it is true we have unfair trade deals. Yeah, I do want prosperity. I do have family losing their jobs. Yeah, I kind of get it because the Republican establishment doesn't want him. And I ran to all these Bernie supporters yesterday that told me, hey, we like Trump too. We're just going with somebody different. So America hasn't fully woken up, but America to a certain extent gets it. And all over the world, nationalist, anti-globalist candidates from the right and the left are being elected. And a Trump-type guy is about to get elected in the Philippines. You saw what happened in Austria 2 weeks ago. Nationalist. And they demonize it. And they focus in, you know, in Germany on a few skinheads or whatever. I'm not worried about the skinheads, folks. I'm worried about 5 million jihadis being brought in who are already attacking. And when they do attack, I get to hear how I'm going to lose more liberty. Let me tell you something. If I saw millions of skinheads running around saying they were going to take over, then I'd be concerned. But you know what? Skinheads don't try to make women wear hoods over their heads and sexually mutilate them. And all I'm saying is I don't like skinheads. But man, I mean, the Muslim system, the dominant Muslim system, is a frickin' brainwashing cult of absolute hell, the most illiberal, anti-freedom-based system the world has ever seen. And I just want to say to the pseudo-intellectual leftists out there, you're in a cult. The fact that you're so allied with Islam. And I knew they were doing a clash of civilizations. I was against these wars to take out more moderate people in the Middle East. I know the globalists have the Middle East slated for absolute bedlam and deindustrialization and enslavement. But to see the bold double cross of them flooding us with the poorest, most backward, Wahhabiist, Saudi Arabian financed crazies is the globalist deal. We'll flood all the nation states, have everybody fighting with each other, have no excellence with the multinationals above the law ruling over it because they're in competition with that. I want to play a bunch of clips. I said I'd get to them, and I have it. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. I'll be taking calls at the bottom of the next hour. 800-259-9231. Long-time callers, first-time callers, whatever. Just please have a good phone. 800-259-9231. But really, I've reached the surreal point in my life where I just can't even believe that stuff I was reading about 20 years ago in different university papers and different publications and in different congressional funding bills. And, you know, they'd have tests back then. They'd have, like, an article in the Washington Post going, there are human animal chimeras in South Korea, Hong Kong, a little closer to home in Costa Rica. And there are some labs here in the U.S., but those are partially classified. And they are part chimpanzee, part human. And I go on air and I read, well, here's the Washington Post saying this. And I get emails going, you're crazy. That's not happening. I read the Washington Post. Now, it's now admitted. And folks, I have hundreds of articles. I haven't even gotten any of them, have I? Because it's just the backdrop. There are hundreds of open fields, thousands of open fields. Just a few years ago, it was hundreds. Thousands of open fields with cloned pigs, cloned sheep, and cloned cows running around. And there are hundreds of open fields, according to MIT, that have part human, part animal cows, part human, part porcine pigs, and they grow humanoids in them. Now, they're very secretive about what's going on with the humanoids, but, you know, they had a big article last week. Researchers in the UK have discovered how to grow embryos up larger in artificial wombs. Oh, it's such a breakthrough. They make it all about that and the ethics of how big to grow it. And, you know, there's more rights for a bunny rabbit to not get tested on than there is humans. But here's the trick. They change the genetic of the human. 1%, they claim it has no human rights, and they gestate them and keep them after birth. I mean, you better know. If they admit 20 years ago they got chimeras in farms all over the place. That's from the Greek, you know, creatures that are multi-animal or centaurs, you know, a body of a man on the top, horse on the bottom. Men redundant. Now we don't need women either. The Guardian. See, And then they release systems that sterilize our normal human activity. Then we have to go have a test tube creature made. And now the corporations, just like they have Terminator seeds, where your seeds won't grow new plants the next year. You got to buy from them each year. Well, how about you can't have kids anymore? You got to go to them. And then they backdoor, just like they do on your cell phone, all the Trojan horses in control. And by the way, they admit that. They already have bioethics boards in the United States and England deciding what will be engineered. And you read these white papers. This is mainstream news going, it'll be wonderful. Knowing that normal humans are bigoted and hateful biologically because of our race ancestry, we're going to have five gay daddies have a baby, and it'll be five people. Oh, that's never been done. Oh, that sounds really good. But it's okay because it's gay. Five gay men are going to create the new egg and the sperm. And this is what they admit they're already doing. But notice they don't say three men, two women. They say five gay men. Oh, how wonderful, mad science. Five gay men? Well, then why didn't you say so? There's a total revolution coming, and they're not going to give everybody access to the life extension, which they've already got, by the way. And so they're all on power mad trips with the technology they've stolen from humanity. And I'm just trying to get people to understand, you don't make a deal with this. This is alien. I don't know what's behind it at the final equation. The devil, whatever you want to call it, fallen angel. I mean, come on, folks, read the Bible. Fallen angel, I mean, here to destroy us, here to take over, here to overthrow God's creation. And then they get control, and they're doing exactly what the Bible said they do. Some big stuff's going now. And everything else is window dressing. And then somebody like Donald Trump, who just doesn't hate America. He just doesn't have it out for the country. He's like, why do we make bad deals with the communist Chinese and people? It's bad deals. We're not going to do that. That's his crime. And his crime is my crime. It's your crime of caring about humanity. They don't like confident, successful alpha males that want to build a strong world and who enjoy prosperity. These are twisted, sniveling people that do not like you to do well. Their pleasure is running your life. They're like a homeowners association. This has happened before. That gets so arrogant, they start claiming they own your house because they found, you know, the wrong kind of grass growing in one area of your yard, even though you didn't plant it there. They had somebody come on, take a photo of it, and then they try to take your house. And it turns out they have some homeowners associations that are rackets that extort people. That's not their right. That's not their, but they do it in groups. These criminals get together and they convince themselves that it's okay what they're doing to us. But who's more evil, them or those of us that are aware of what's happening and just roll over to this? I want to play these clips. I'm going to come back from break, play them, and then I'm going to start the next hour, take 30 minutes of calls. And then I have Leanne and Biggs coming in to break some big news with us. But this story up on Infowars.com is so huge. You know, I started talking about it 15 minutes ago and then never got to it because my mind, you know, just moves through the spectrum of information. I started to tell you, I talked to Democrats and they're now supporting Trump. And the numbers show that. It's why they're so scared. CNN struggles to find Democrats not voting for Trump. Infowars.com. It was not easy here to randomly find people who want Hillary Clinton for president, CNN reported, adding that out of nearly 20 random Democrats they interviewed, nearly all of them were already supporting Trump. Federal rules and regulators, many of them pushed by the United Nations, have shut down the coal mines in the county, and it goes through the area of where this happened. But it's the same thing. You can go anywhere in the country and talk to people, and they're actually supporting Trump. The article's on Infowars.com. And CNN had to admit it. They just can't even find anybody in coal mining country, mainly Democrats historically, who's supporting Hillary. And if he gets that same populist message out everywhere, it's game over. Now, before I go to break, we're running 10% off an Inns tonight. The food special did in last night. on all preparedness items, non-GMO, heirloom seeds that actually create new seeds, you know, for thousands of generations after that, super high quality, shortwave radios, water filtration systems, Infowarsstore.com, 10% off. All the nutraceuticals, you name it, at Instadyne at midnight, 10% off. We also have a big water special that we're launching today. So find out more at Infowarsstore.com about that situation. And I'm unable with My Patriot Supply. We sell their full spectrum of high-quality food with our private label as well, Infowars Select, InfowarsSelect.com, to offer 30, 40% off on the entire spectrum. But what I can do, what we're launching, it should be up on the site now. I came in this morning and decided to do it, and I made some phone calls. We can offer the four best sellers, 4-week, 3-month, 6-month, and 1-year. You can customize these two for 40% off on those. So whether it's G-Shock watches or optics, just anything survival-related is 10% off and 40% off on the four top sellers. And I can run that. I've been authorized to run that until next week, next Sunday or Monday. So InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com for the nutraceuticals. Call toll-free 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139. And also I want to thank all the PrisonPlanet.tv members that see the nightly news and the films and special reports and more. Each membership's $5.95 a month. 20 people can use each membership. It's a great way to reach out to friends and family with the truth. And some will listen, some won't. Your job is just to tell people so that, you know, you've done your job. That's my job as well. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. But, I mean, it's surreal. I mean, we're just in open world government. It's absolutely tyrannical. It's anti-human. It's allied with every form of wickedness we can imagine. The jihadis, the pedophile groups, you name it. And they have a hunger to dominate good men and women. They come to kill, steal, and destroy because they love their father. They love death. So many people would warn me, your children will grow up so fast, better spend time with them. And I didn't spend the time I wanted to with my children, and now they're growing up really fast. Don't let them steal your reality. Don't let them steal the universe from you and let you think that mainstream media and culture is all there is. That's all I'm saying is make a break with these people. And realize that the globalists are very cynical, bad people. And they don't have goodwill. I walked out of it, Captain America. And they put out the second one, Winter Soldier, that had a really good plot based on, you know, it was a good film. I'm not against superheroes and fantasy. They're all archetypes. But I walked out halfway through it. I read the synopsis once I got home so I could comment on it. It's exactly what I thought it was. A bunch of world government propaganda. And it's got false flags in it and things like that. But they're not movies anymore. They're 2.5-hour globalist brainwashing scams where they'll have the stuff for Africa and the stuff for China and the stuff for Europe and the stuff for Latin America and where everybody gets their little part of the movie. So it's an international bestseller worldwide. But it's not about the money. It's about selling that image and that idea. And I know everybody knows that, but still, people just sit there and watch this crap, and they make it unwatchable. If it's going to be propaganda, at least make it watchable. But it's so dumbed down. It's so dumbed down, I just go read the synopsis. Because it's just, it's horrible. It's like the Fast and Furious movies. You know, the first few were okay. It was more just hot rods racing each other. By the end, it was like cartoons, guys driving cars 5 miles down mountains, running into 4-foot-tall boulders. Just total fantasy land. Mario Brothers is more real. And people believe this stuff because the globalists are using psych warfare to overthrow reality so that when they start doing really bad stuff, people are already desensitized to it and accept it. And I know you know that, but let's go to John Kerry. I mentioned this the last couple hours, never got to it. Here he is at a commencement speech, taking a quote, swipe at Trump, saying, get ready for a borderless world. He looks like somebody from the Adams family. He's got a rubber face. He's a lying criminal that backed ISIS and Al-Qaeda. And then he says we've got to have open borders, but checkpoints for citizens internally. When they say open borders, they mean world government running over your sovereignty because these traitors have transferred power to themselves offshore. Let's play the clip.
Many of you were in elementary school when you learned the toughest lesson of all on 9/11. Oh. There are no walls big enough to stop people from anywhere, tens of thousands of miles away, who are determined to take their own lives while they target others.
So,
I think that everything that we've lived and learned tells us that we will never come out on top if we accept advice from soundbite salesmen and carnival barkers who pretend the most powerful country on earth can remain great.
We'll be back with the rest of the clip where he says get rid of the borders. But this is the carnival barker. These are the people that lie. These are the known quantities, the frauds. Flicks his tongue like a snake the whole time. When I was growing up reading Nietzsche, started reading him when I was about 12. I really thought, really, that which doesn't kill you only makes you stronger? But as I get older, I realize that that is absolutely true. That which doesn't kill you only makes you stronger. And the things I've learned about media and just in my 21 years on air is just mind-blowing. We're going to go to break in a moment, come back and go to Peter and Darren and Bill and Parker and Anthony and all the big news. I went to the Kerry clip late, so I got cut off by the break there. Was, you know, those are satellites, so I can't really skip breaks at the end of the hour. But saying, hey, we don't have borders, and then making fun of Donald Trump and, you know, flicking his tongue and calling him a carnival show barker. You've got these criminal mummies up here that he's been backing ISIS, backing Al-Qaeda with John McCain and Obama. It's all come out, Benghazi, you name it. And he says that we learned on 9/11 we're not safe, so why even have borders? But when I flew in from Mexico last year and I had bought my father a $1,800 watch for his birthday that was coming up, I didn't buy it in Mexico because you could get a little bit cheaper there or was trying to get around the duty or whatever. I never have time to shop, so I'm on vacation for 5 days. I go to the shops. Oh, there's a nice watch. I'll get my dad a watch. A little dive watch, a tag. And they sit there and put me in a database when I'm buying it. I think it's weird. And then I'm going through the thing into customs, and I'd put on there, you know, $2,000 or whatever because I bought some other stuff. And the woman goes, did you buy a watch? And I said, yeah. Well, how much was it? I don't know. It's in that bag. She goes, uh-huh. You're going back here to get basically searched. And I'd even put it on there, but it was just an excuse to mess with me. Everything is totally, and I went and looked it up. Sure enough, they got a database back and forth. Everything is totally tracked. These countries are all working together. The corporations are laundering the drug money. They're involved in every crime you can imagine. And then they sit there and micromanage. I was flying out to Vegas a few years ago to be on Jesse Ventura's TV show. They were shooting it there because it's cheaper than shooting in L.A. There's a rocket base outside there we were going to cover, so that was the main reason. But I'm there, and there's a guy on the plane who just had his 20 silver coins taken by the TSA. And then sure enough, I didn't even know it, but I Googled it when we're on the plane about to take off. And it was all over the country. They were taking people's coins. And by the way, he was going to a silver and gold convention. He was going to sell his coins to have money to then, you know, go do whatever he was going to engage in. And it's just, wow, that's such a free country. You can't fly with 20 silver coins. And then other people start talking on the plane about stuff they had taken. It's just all part of training us that we're prisoners. And I'm going from memory. There's been so many of those cases. It's just we're treated like slaves. We have no rights. But, oh, we're going to bring in unlimited Muslims from war-torn areas, cover up the actual numbers, and then we're going to comply with their culture. That's how much these people hate the West. They're out to get us. All right, I want to go to your phone calls, and then I do want to go through a bunch of news. We have Leanne McAdoo coming in here to talk about Facebook censorship. Facebook, admittedly, censors. They want to keep it secret. There's this false argument. Well, that's their corporate platform. They can do whatever they want. And they've had mainstream media running around, what's left of it, you know, in the last few months, saying, hey, you own Facebook. Censor more. Just don't allow Trump people or pro-gun people on there, period. But see, they want to do it stealthily. They want to advertise it's open. They want everybody's data. They want you to be there so that you're not on other platforms building those. They just want to have you there so they can control you. People say, well, then why are you on Facebook or Twitter? Well, it's simple. Because that's where the fight is. Because they don't want me there. I'm there to expose them on their own platform. They don't count on us being bold. They don't count on us being aggressive. They don't count on us taking action. I'm telling you, these people are easily defeated. I snuck into Bohemian Grove because I'd snuck into some military training operations and been covered by the British media and John Ronson, who wrote the book, Men Who Stare at Goats, and them and a bunch of other big hit Hollywood movies. But he wrote books that were made into films. And he was covering Waco for a TV show he was doing for, I think it was BBC. And he said, have you heard of Bohemian Grove? There are these weird rituals. And this is like 1998, like a year and a half before I even infiltrated. And I said, yeah, I heard all that, Skull and Bones, but I said, I don't go there. I just cover, you know, Second Amendment, the Federal Reserve's private and stuff like that, and Waco is wrong, and, you know, I'm just a constitutionalist. And he's like, listen, I got an insider. I can't sneak in there because of liability. Our insurance won't cover it. You have snuck into military bases and things, and you've done this before, and we're going to pay you to go in. It's only 4 days. We'll get you out there. You'll meet with our insider, all the rest of it. And I said, sure, I'll do it. A year passes. He calls up. He goes, we're ready. You know, in 6 months, you're ready to go. So 6 months passes, and we fly out there. We do it. I go in. Dozens of people have gone in from CBS News and People Magazine and you name it. All got arrested. All got stopped. But I prayed before I went in that God give me the strength to get in and to be undetected and to get it all. And I went in, I rode in on the bus, the parking lot, went to, got questioned by the Secret Service 3 times, the sheriff's deputies once. Successfully, you know, talked to them, knew enough about the internal passwords and things to get in and get the footage of them engaging in a satanic ritual. And I'm not bragging that I was successful at doing that, but I've always been successful. All the other reporters were so arrogant that they would march into the different camps and begin basically conducting interviews with people and asking them questions. So, of course, they would all go, wait one moment, and then they'd get the police. That's what I mean about the establishment media. They're all so arrogant and so insecure. They overcompensate that they all just stick out like sore thumbs. They just can't get anything done. They're losers. But I'm here to tell you, when we take action against these people, they're paper tigers. They're straw dogs. They're not real. It's all bravado. And that's why they've sought to dumb everybody down. And I know I'm stating the obvious here, but this is the reality. Let me hit some headlines and I'm going to your phone calls. Roger Stone, Ryan and Priebus planning to extort Trump at RNC may even try to steal the nomination. That is back on by these two crazy men, the Speaker of the House and then his little buddy, Priebus. I mean, Priebus looks like a bad guy from a movie, just another arrogant. What is it about weak men that have some intellect and know how to scheme that they think they're smarter than everybody? And there's a softness to them. There's a Glenn Beck softness. Continuing, Donald Trump won't rule out effort to remove Paul Ryan as convention chairman. Absolutely. Punish him. Run him into the ground. You've already defeated him, Trump, with grassroots movements. They tried to openly say you wouldn't get it regardless. That failed. They had to back off. Now they're scheming again. Run him over again. Don't give these dogs quarter. They don't give us quarter. They're dishonorable, dishonest, Jacobins, all of them. They are Jacobins. They are Jacobins. Jacobin of old, Jacobin of today, Jacobin of the future falls. So sick of them. Trump slams Hillary Clinton as nasty, mean enabler of husband's affairs and sexual improprieties. Absolutely, he's going there. Donald Trump calls Hillary Clinton nasty, mean enabler. Donald Trump, enabler in sexual attacks. Does it have to be unified? Defiant Trump says he can win without backing of Republican leaders and says party doesn't need to show united support. The people that have hijacked the party and are running it with the globalists are the enemy occupiers. We're going to go to that clip of him saying doesn't need to be unified here in just a moment. In fact, let's go ahead and go to that clip now.
Does it have to be unified? I'm very different than everybody else, perhaps, that's ever run for office. I actually don't think so. I think that
it doesn't have to be.
No,
unified.
I don't think so. I think it would be better if it were unified. I think it would be there would be something good about it. But I don't think it actually has to be
but
unified in the
split,
traditional sense. Because I think I'm going to go out and I'm going to get millions of people from the Democrats. I'm going to get Bernie people
already
to
happened.
Vote because they like me on trade. I have to stay true to my principles also. And I'm a conservative. But don't forget, this is called the Republican Party. It's not called the Conservative Party. You know, there are conservative parties. This is called the Republican Party.
Yeah, and the people that claim they're the conservatives, Paul Ryan and people, it's all just fiction. It's all fiction. They'd rather Hillary. They've said that. I mean, he should resign as the speaker. There should be a recall movement now, and there is with Sarah Palin. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and sit back while they gut the Republic and bring in world tyranny when the people we know running the show are out to get us. I mean, I'm not going to do it. I want to go to Peter here in just a moment. Then we'll go to Bill and Parker and Anthony and Darren and others. Peter, thank you for holding. Thank you for calling in. I've covered a lot so far. What did you want to chime in on today?
Alex, good afternoon. I'm calling from Florida. I'd like to ask you, why do people contribute to the Republican Party if they're voting for Trump? Nobody's saying a word about this. I don't understand why Stone isn't saying anything. I don't understand why you aren't saying anything. Withdraw your contributions to the Republican Party.
Well, and here's the problem. I totally agree with you. No, I totally. This gets into all the minutiae, but the party in a general election gets all the funds. It has to go through that once you get to that point, once you leave the primaries. Okay, so they've set the rules like that. That's why the presumptive nominee and then the nominee becomes the head of it and controls it. They're saying, no, you're not. So that's the issue. We need to fight and not let them be in control of it. The way the election law is written, it has to go through them or they indict you. I mean, look what they did to Dinesh D'Souza. So do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I understand that. But the Republican Party has been subverted by Karl Rove, Priebus.
Absolutely. I hear you, brother. So what do? We call for Paul Ryan to not just be removed as the chairman of the Republican Party. He needs to be removed from the speakership. They knew this was coming, and they got rid of Boehner because he was so reviled and hated he couldn't lead this. They put Pretty Boy up there. And I agree with you. So we need to move against Paul Ryan now. What do you think?
Ryan is up for re-election in November in his home district. I mean, if we take him out there and support his competitor, we stand a better chance.
No, that's it. So the way we recall him is everybody gets behind his competitor. And Sarah Palin's coming in. God bless her. And so just, folks, if you're angry, let's. This is war. This is political war. And we need to put pressure. I agree with you. That's what Stone was saying. We need to put pressure on them now, and Trump is. He's not going to let them make a deal where they maintain control of the RNC. He takes control of the RNC as the nominee.
Jeez. But, nobody's saying anything about withdrawing the contributions. I mean, Stone's not saying anything.
No, I hear you. No, I mean, I get the leverage. You need to tell Ryan. No, that's your leverage. You tell Paul Ryan, and you tell all of them. You tell the media, because Ryan already knows. He'll ignore you. We're not going to give donations if you don't make Trump the head of the RNC. So you need to step down. You say you're for Hillary over him. You're disqualified on its face. It'd be like if you were the football coach of a team and you said, you know, I don't like our team now. I want the other team to win this game. They would say, step down, resign, you piece of crap. I put a tweet out earlier saying Paul Ryan should resign as Speaker of the House, resign as the head of the RNC, and he should go be the head of Hillary's campaign. And that's not tongue-in-cheek. How do they insult our intelligence? And I get your anger, Peter. They insult our intelligence, and they tell us that we support Hillary over him, and we're going to run the party. No. You have disqualified yourself. Do you agree with that statement?
Exactly. I do agree with it, 100%.
What's your gut tell you about Trump? I mean, he's sweeping with Democrats everywhere. They're trying to spin the books and the polls, but the numbers really show Trump is going to beat Hillary in a landslide. I just pray to God they don't put a bullet in him.
I get the same feeling with Donald Trump as I did with Ronald Reagan in 1980. I wasn't able to vote in 1980. I was too young. I voted for Reagan in 84. I get the same feeling from Donald Trump as I did with Ronald Reagan. He's going to make this country great again. I'm going to be able to feel secure in my own country.
Just having a president that didn't have to get us is going to fix everything. These globalists have hijacked us. They're the enemy, folks. Donald Trump knows it. Great points, Peter. We'll be back with more calls. Stay with us. Anthony in Texas, Parker in Florida, Darren, Greg, Bill, we're going to all of you. Let's talk to Parker in Florida. You're on the air worldwide.
Hello, Bear Klinger, Parker, Pasco County here. How you doing?
Good, brother. Come on up. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Through Cracker County, Pasco. You ever been down here?
I've been in a lot of places in Florida. I forget all the counties, brother.
Oh, I know. Well, anyways, I wanted to find out, who's your favorite general?
George Washington.
I never thought I heard you say it.
George Washington.
Oh, you must be a racist, though, really. George Washington.
Yeah, there's nothing intellectual anymore. It's just racist, homophobe. I know it's of a bunch of poor college students who have no future, no jobs, no nothing, running around desperate, mad because Donald Trump didn't want the communist Chinese murderers to screw us over. I know he's so horrible.
Personally, I like Patton. I'm probably more of a racist for that, you know. But anyways, what do you know about this new transition of power executive order?
Well, I don't know which executive order you're talking about. They've got hundreds of them on the books. They reaffirm each new president that just establishes executive rule, dictatorship. It's forced labor camps. It's all in there. They've never implemented all of it, but they think they can operate because they pass laws. Like the Republicans said, your vote doesn't count. We passed the law. Well, you know, that dog doesn't hunt, as they say, Parker.
Oh, wow. Well,
Parker, God bless you. I appreciate
it.
Go ahead.
It's all over YouTube, so I guess anyone who wants to figure out, maybe judge for yourself.
Yes, sir. Well, you didn't give me a specific executive order, but there are a bunch of them doing that. Yes, sir. Thank you, Parker. Anthony in Texas wants to talk about Ivanka Trump, which is always a nice subject to discuss. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Thanks for having me on.
You bet.
I want to pre-qualify myself first by saying that I've been listening to your show both on your public access and radio since you started here in Austin. Probably haven't missed more than a month of shows in the entire, 17, 18
years.
Boy,
you've seen it all.
So.
Back when I'd be in the control room with a light on my face. You know.
Yeah. I'd come home late at night and watch that, and I thought, well, here's somebody who knows what's going on. I got into the Patriot Movement. I'm a little bit older than you are, you know, in my 20s. And so, you know, before the internet, you had to go to meetings and pass out flyers and literature and things like that to find out anything about any of these.
And boy, aren't you vindicated? World government's now out in the open. Everything we warned about is now known. We've advanced the ball so far. That's why I say we're in good standing as pro-humans worldwide if we just press the matter and realize we are winning the war right now. Sorry, go ahead.
And I couldn't agree more, and that's why, you know, I called to get on. I've never even attempted to call before I got on almost instantly, so I appreciate that. I guess that was
appreciate you, brother. Go ahead.
You know, I'd want to pre-qualify myself with that, and also I've been in the same business basically that Ed Group's been in for about 25 years as well, so I can, you know, kind of give the credence and the acknowledgement that the products that you sell that are based on a lot of his products that I've used in my clinic actually are the real deal. And it's an important point because how people get toxic in this world via chemicals and all sorts of things, not only what they hear and see, but what's in their body, is very important to understand that, you know, it puts people in a trance and it keeps them
absolutely. People are drugged up by design. That's the admitted plan. Now, you want to talk about Ivanka Trump, though, I'm told.
And I'm getting to that, but this is my point. You know, it's almost like you're under mind control when you're that toxic. You really can't hear the truth. My concern is this about Ivanka. I've just read the book by Roger Stone and the other gentleman about the Clintons, and I saw the family interview with the Trumps, and Ivanka Trump, you know, they asked her about her relationship with Chelsea Clinton, and they're good friends, evidently. You know, that's well-known in the world. And Chelsea Clinton knows, obviously, that she is not Bill Clinton's daughter, that she is Webb Hubble's daughter. And that the information, I think the collusion between people who are really wealthy has to be carefully watched. And I'm not saying that Ivanka is her dad's handler in any way. All I'm saying is that she has his ear very closely.
No, I hear you. Look, some of the past Clinton connections are very troubling, and we're watching those very closely, just like the Ted Cruz connections to the Bushes. And if Trump starts going sideways on us, it's a big issue. But you're absolutely right. But I mean, he had to operate in New York. Trump has played both sides. And if he is the double crosser, he'll be the biggest Benedict Arnold in history. And he will destroy his name and dynasty forever. But if he was the guy to help turn America around and defeat globalism, he'll be the ultimate superhero, George Washington 2.0. We're going to be going back to your phone calls here in a little while for Darren and others that have been patiently holding, Manny and Alex and Bill and Greg, just briefly, because I want to cover two big topics with you guys here in just a second. I was forced by the manufacturer, the producer, My Patriot Supply. We sell their full spectrum of food, best out there, lowest price. That's why they're our sponsor. We could have 15 sponsors that I endorse, but I just choose to go with what I think is the best deal, what I buy for my family. And I've been stocking up. I'm getting more in here for the office, medical supplies, you name it, hoping that things don't get as bad as they look like they could. But understanding the elite are buying storable food, all the stuff's going on, now really is the time to get prepared with insurance you can eat. With inflation and the rest of it, a couple of years from now, just eat your investment. So this is the type of insurance which you 100% can use, another win-win-win. And the small profit we make off discounting it funds our operation. Not that profit's bad. I want to have the best price and sell tons of it. And that's actually been working. It's helping fund us to go to Bilderberg to cover the RNC, DNC, try to hire a few more crew members. I mean, this is the win-win. So thank you for shopping with InfoWarsStore.com. You're making it all possible. But I did talk to him this morning, and I said, look, I twisted your arm. I extended it, you know, like a week. I promised I'd end it Sunday. We did. You've got 60 different packages or so. Can we just take the four best sellers and do it for another week at 40% off? And they said, you're the one that's not making really much money. I said, well, actually, look, I am, because we're absolutely dominating the market doing this. People are shopping. They know this is a good deal. So for a limited time, get 40% off. This is 30 to 40. No, I'm going 40 with this because it's only four items, so it's 40. Off the retail price of our best-selling InfoWars Select Storable Food at InfoWarsStore.com. We don't know how long we can continue this. They think till this weekend. All InfoWars Select Foods have a shelf life of 25 years, made in the USA. Food prices are going up around the world, and now is the best time to get started to prepare, I think. Also, ending tonight, all of the preparedness items from G-Shock watches to optics to non-GMO heirloom seeds to water filtration systems to shortwave radios, it's all 10% off at InfoWarsStore.com. That's Strategic Relocation, the book, Strategic Relocation, the film, hundreds of items, privacy and security, block-it-pocket type systems.
Battery pack thing's amazing.
Absolutely. We've got more of those in stocks. The best compact, highly tested battery, less than Amazon sells it for. Dozens of different plug-ins. Jump your car. Mm-hmm. I've actually used one before. I mean, it's amazing. The miniaturization that's taking place. All this stuff's 10% off, already the lowest prices. Anthroplex is back in stock. Supermail, of course, has been sold out. So much more at InfoWarsStore.com. Or call toll-free 888-253-3139. 888-253-3139. They can answer all your questions. Till like 6 o'clock at night, our own crew answers the phones. Then it goes to an answering service we've had for 20 years. But they can take your orders as well. But our crew really is awesome. They've got all the inside baseball for you if you want to call 888-253-3139. And this is free association. We're selling high-quality products at very low prices. So whether it's a book, a video, heirloom seeds, or a Hillary for President t-shirt, or all the nutraceuticals discounted 10%, it's going to end today. That will end tonight at midnight. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. Okay. First off, Leanne McAdoo. Missed you in the last week. Good to have you back here in Austin. Biggs, good to have you here, my friend. I want to talk about just the general state of the world with you briefly before we get into these other two topics, censorship and what's going on with Uber in Austin. This is a microcosm of the rest of the world, obviously. Both of you have been covering this. The Trump phenomenon, just briefly, Leanne, and then Joe Biggs, where would you say it is right now? Where's your evolution with Trump? What do you make of the story up on InfoWars.com? John Kerry, saying borderless world government. In the EU, they're saying if England tries to leave, it might start a war. I mean, it really shows how we're already captured under globalism, mm-hmm. under these deals, and you know, just the state of the world. Where do you see all this going?
Well, I mean, I'm kind of there with you, where I was really enjoying the Trump phenomenon and how he was kind of speaking out and separating himself from the rest of the establishment. So it'll be interesting to see what happens now that they're all deciding to align behind him. Just make sure he doesn't get compromised. So I think, you're always bringing that up, that it's going to be really important that we hold him to the fire, you know, so that he doesn't sell out at this point, which is what we've seen politicians do when they make it, you know, you don't get this far. So
I agree that we got to watch for him to be compromised, just slowly wanting to make deals.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, we already now have Priebus, the minion of Paul Ryan, saying they're just going to keep the RNC money and not even give it to Trump because they want Hillary in. How could you be the head of the Republican Party and the RNC and say, we're not going to let Trump become the head, which they're supposed to do by law, and we want Hillary to win? I mean, these guys are really arrogant. What do they think of their constituents, Joe Biggs?
I mean, when you go to these events, there are people driving from Canada, from Alaska. I interviewed some guys from Alaska. They're making huge treks, journeys to come to these Trump events. You don't see people going to Hillary Clinton events mm-hmm. from five states away or another country to hear her talk because everyone knows she's corrupt garbage.
Right.
But people are taking these long trips, spending money, their savings, to go and hear this man speak, to get a chance to be in his presence, because there is a giant movement mm-hmm. sweeping across the country right
and
now.
And whether he ends up being good or not, he's pushing nationalism. He's saying things that scare the elite. Mm-hmm. And the people involved are involved for the right reason, trying to promote freedom against globalism. So you can't lose by engaging.
Right.
Yeah.
The curtain has been pulled back with this election cycle, and that's really exciting.
And you know, it's interesting, you know, the whole thing about the curtain being pulled back and people actually having the election process explained to him now, because a lot of people didn't really know how things worked.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting how you can see that Bernie's having a lot of this stuff stolen from him, but he doesn't say anything. He's not coming out and complaining in a sense.
He's totally rigged.
Which it just doesn't, I don't get, like, if you're really trying to be this popular guy out there and you really want to make a stand against Hillary Clinton and take her out, why don't you expose some of this stuff and come out and say something? Like,
right.
he has more people coming to his events. He's just as popular as Trump on the other side of the spectrum. And yet he doesn't really, he's not shaking anything up. He's not putting any kind of fear whatsoever in her eyes. I mean, right. And he could do it. He could take it from her, but you just don't see him trying.
Yeah.
I totally agree. Very salient points. All I know is anybody saying their board's crazy. This is such an exciting time to be alive. Let's shift gears first off into these two articles, because it dovetails with what Leanne wanted to cover, and I'm glad she's going to be doing a special report on this for the Nightly News tonight. Researchers say computer screens change how you think about what you read. And it just gets into the programming Washington Post. This is just the flavor of the news today. London Telegraph, parents, smartphones harming children's ability to hold conversations, say teachers.
Mm.
Well, yeah, all the numbers show it's brain damaging. That's why Steve Jobs wouldn't let his kids have them. Gizmodo, I've got another one here. Former Facebook worker, we routinely suppress conservative news. Got another one right here. Facebook, that's Gizmodo. This is Daily Caller. Facebook made Black Lives Matter trend by inserting it into news feeds. Yes, it's White House run, The Hill report, Facebook omitting conservative topics from trending lists. You know, people over the last 6 months as we exposed this, and it's always been going on, but it's getting worse. They'd say, you know, hey, it's their site. Yeah, but they have terms of service. We're not breaking those. They don't want to admit they're censoring, but they are, and they're doing it more and more. So this really shows when they meet with the Communist Party chiefs on how to, quote, censor. He keeps meeting with them, Zuckerberg, who calls his users dumb effers.
Right.
I'm going into Facebook to say, hey, don't be dumb effers and get involved. But the good news is we've been hammering this. Others have been hammering this. Drudge has been hammering this. And so they're having to admit it. And their own employees are saying, yes, we go in. You know, go back to Benghazi. Navy SEALs will send out a meme, you know, saying, you know, basically, you know, she stood down and we died, showing four dead guys. And I remember we would try to share that, and they suspended us for a day and said, this is not authorized. I mean, this is a big deal, like the Soviet Union, if we let this happen. Leanne?
Yeah, I agree. They're trying to put themselves as this non-biased news aggregator, but they are specifically choosing what you're allowed to see and suppressing any conservative viewpoints or injecting topics that they say, well, this needs to go viral, so let's make this. And then they put it out there as if it's just this, you know, natural thing that's people are all excited about this, talking about it. Meanwhile, they're the ones that force Black Lives Matter.
I mean, it's like
mainstream.
It's like a daily thing. I get people writing me all the time. We can't see the article you share. We can't see the InfoWars article. Why can't we get it? When I click on the video, it won't play. I can't see Alex's Facebook mention. You know, they are.
And then the engineers come out. I mean, 6 months ago, I started pointing out this was happening. People are like, oh, shut up, conspiracy theorists. Now the engineers are going public. They get blackballed for this, going, no, we're ordered to do this. There's algorithms. And people need to get upset about it. And listen, folks, Don't get discouraged just because we're having an effect. When you see a Drudge link or an InfoWars link or WorldNet Daily or whatever the case may be, and you can't find it, go to InfoWars to find it, to put it out on your own site. And you can also culture jam, and because I've done tests to see what works, and maybe say, hey, Miley Cyrus talked about, you know, her new boyfriend, and have it be a link to us.
Yeah.
You know, take our stuff, change the headline, sabotage the enemy.
That's what I have to do. I have to put like Tom Brady or something like that, or something about football, and all of a sudden it'll get like 20,000 shares. But if I put, you know, Target bathroom policy change to allow men into women's restrooms, all of a sudden it's like 10 shares, 20 likes. But if I put Tom Brady in there, or the Patriots, or something like that, or Obama,
and again,
it's with Kanye West. And
it's not because that's popular. They admit Kanye West, Black Lives Matter, Beyonce. That's the Super Bowl. That's the CIA. That's right. Viacom. That's Fox.
Right.
Saying go out and attack the police.
Well, plus too, with all people are already self-censoring because they know how much we're being surveilled. So they already are beginning to self-censor. So they don't want to share those topics that are really controversial.
Well, that's it.
They want to talk about football and whatever.
Exactly. Just like they said, we're going to have a new social rating in China where if you behaved yourself, you're allowed to have high ratings on the web and buy and sell.
Right.
This is the mark of the beast. Leanne, go ahead.
Yeah. Sorry. And then you see the Facebook employees put out this internal poll, and it specifically says, what responsibility does Facebook have to help prevent President Trump in 2017? I mean, so this is an internal poll that they're asking with their employees.
And they only put the poll out to make them feel like they're involved in the process when the algorithms are already in place.
Right. I mean, so this just lets you see how much Facebook could be like one social network that could have a.
And look at Zuckerberg. He's effect. A CIA front on record right. from Harvard, preying on everyone as a little bastard predator who thinks he's smart. He's an arrogant, anti-human prick.
He doesn't want walls, but he's got a wall around his place. He doesn't want arms. Or he doesn't want you to have guns, but he's got, like a 10-man team that goes jogging with him every day strapped. You know, it's ridiculous.
And there's another story out about how regulators in Washington are now talking again, like they do every year, about increasing and tightening the rules on the political speech on the web because they say the new media is becoming too powerful, too influential.
Yeah.
They're not talking about Facebook, though.
And they've already said they're going to just take your election from you. Oh, Bernie's winning? Just give it to Hillary. Oh, Trump's winning? Just give it to whoever. But notice, it didn't sell with the Trump movement because Trump would come out and say it was a fraud.
Right.
You've got to go the next level and say this is baloney. You've got to call them instead of just mainstream media said it must be true. Again, it's a facade, folks.
Well, they're so confused right now. They were so able to sideline Ron Paul, Rand Paul, all these guys right. and make them seem kooky for being constitutionalists. But they haven't been able to do it with Trump, and he's been able to bust through these, you know, walls
well, that's
and everything
because
they've
the,
ever done.
The Liberty movement was already cresting. Trump just grabbed it.
Right.
But if you look at he's had the most people ever vote for him in the Republican Party.
Mm-hmm.
Hillary Clinton in 2012 had more people vote for her then compared to now. So how is she even relevant in any kind of way? Her numbers are so far down.
Did you see the article that is on InfoWars.com? It should go viral. That Kit Daniels did with CNN admitting because they're live. And they go to like a Democrat event and they can't. And they're all for Trump.
Yeah.
And they're like, no. And they're like, oh, well, cut to commercial. Again, folks.
Yeah. Or they try to put down the person. That when they interviewed the one black guy that was at the Trump rally and they thought he was going to, you know, give them the point of view they were expecting. And then they cut away. Oh, well, obviously he doesn't represent all of the African-Americans that are, you know.
And that's a classic bait and switch where they say, don't go to the Tea Party. It's all racist.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's hard to get people who aren't, quote, white to go to it. It's the media saying it's white to make that happen. The last thing they want is all to come together around basic freedom. It's just so diabolical.
Right. And of course, we know Zuckerberg has political agenda. And so even with this article that came out, he said, oh, well, we didn't suppress any stories that had to do with Facebook. We kind of left those alone. Meanwhile, we reported on this, and this came out of Breitbart, too, last year, where he says he didn't censor any content that was undermining the immigration agenda. So they said, oh, we didn't mess with that.
Which isn't true. They constantly block us.
Yeah, whenever you want to put out job reports, demonstrate.
He told Merkel, the German chancellor, he was going to censor 3 months ago.
Exactly. And so they're trying to paint themselves as this unbiased place, but they are really controlling the narrative.
Sure.
I mean, there's a Kill Donald Trump page up on Facebook right. they won't take down.
Or ISIS.
Where they organize how to murder him.
Yeah, but if
I guarantee you, if I organize that, the Secret Service would rightfully be here in hours.
Yeah, if you put up a thing that said beat Bernie or whatever like that, like beat him and had pictures of like people clubbing seals or whatever like that. That would get taken down. And like you said, Secret Service would show up and like, what did you really mean by that? Are you trying to harm this person? But you don't care that people are openly rapping and making videos about killing Donald Trump, waving guns around. There's a guy on Facebook that just put out a video the other day where he's got two guns and he's looking in the camera. He's like, I'm going to kill you, MF, or if I ever see you, I'm going to kill your wife. I'm going to kill your kids. And right. That could be on Facebook. But if I post a picture and like say, for instance, if I were to take a Mossberg 500 and shoot a Clinton book or whatever like that with it, they would take that as something completely
right.
The wrong
oh,
way.
Man, I tell you.
But these kids can sit here and threaten to kill a presidential candidate.
Right.
Well, what happens is they've got actuaries set up and algorithms. When something starts going viral, they just kill it.
Yeah.
And now they just don't let the videos
Twitter does it
from
as well.
Facebook. They just don't let us share them.
Right.
It doesn't matter because what's happening is I go on the videos and I go, they're censoring this. So everybody else copies it to their channels and they don't already have algorithms there. And then it dominates. So,
right. And that's it is like you have to call it out when you see it. And, you know, thankfully we have such great info warriors out there. They, you know, take action.
Well, it shows they're losing the info war. Zuckerberg and others helped fund the Arab Spring to put radical Muslims in control of the Middle East. These are bad people.
Right.
Now, Leon, I want to shift gears into this other subject. Lyft and Uber. All over the world, the different unions are trying to shut it down, the taxi cab unions. I'm all for it. But then the weird part is Uber says they want to have robot cars to get rid of humans next. So they're even more globalist tied into the Democrats. So it's all a bunch of infighting groups. But I mean, how about just individuals can go to an app and then if they want to be a contractor, do it. It's, you know, person beware. I mean, who says I don't get in the car with a crazy taxi cab driver, you know? So a major fight going on. Biggs, tell us what's coming up. You're going to be with us too, Leanne.
Well, the thing is Travis County can earn anywhere from about $8.7 million to $9 million a year on DWIs. So you've got to think we've got about 2 million people. Each DUI costs anywhere from $7,000 to $10,000 per case that you have to pay to the city in fees, court fees, all this stuff. That's revenue they're making. It's a revenue thing. They don't care about stopping driving while intoxicated. They want that money. Mm-hmm. And when they brought in these ride-sharing apps like Lyft and Uber, those numbers drastically dropped.
Right.
You know, 17 to 25%.
That's right, because you can never get a taxi when you want one.
Right.
They're so corrupt. They're so stupid. They're so out of control. But, I mean, I hate to hear Uber's leaving because you go out to dinner, have a couple glasses of wine, you get an Uber.
Right. I use Lyft all the time. I don't like Uber because of what you said earlier, so I don't use Uber at all. I use Lyft all the time.
Well, let's talk about when we come back what's happened.
Yeah.
Just tell folks what's happened.
So what's happened right now is a Prop 1 pass, which means that these ride-sharing groups have to be fingerprinted. They have to have these background checks and all this stuff. And that's another way for the cities to get money.
Sure, and it's not their jurisdiction.
And then they were going to take a percentage of their...
Finishing up, then I'm going to go into the next hour some with the guest host that's coming on so I can finish calls. Oh, maybe you guys just ride shotgun with me, but you were telling a really interesting story about being out in Oregon, Joe. I know you were on the show yesterday with Anthony talking about it. I taped part of the show, and he did the second part live, but I appreciate you coming in on Sunday. But mm-hmm. You were talking about the Hill River Prison shirt. This is really a movement.
It is.
And it's now our best-selling shirt ever. We've come up with a new limited edition design, similar to the last one. It doesn't just support the broadcast, folks. If you get one of these, you're going to meet like-minded people. You're going to have folks trying to buy you dinner and drinks at a restaurant. Joe, describe what happens to you and how many of these you're now seeing on the street.
You know, it's the people who know and watch the show, they all come up to me, want to shake my hand. And it's funny, when I was in Eugene, it was like every 10th person in line, there were thousands of people waiting to see Trump at this convention center. And it was like every 10th person, there'd be like one Pillar for Prison t-shirt or like a family. Like there was a couple, a married couple and their kid, they all had the shirts on. And outside of the events, there were groups of people, like they would like form little cliques of Hillary for Prison groups. And I'm walking around filming, you know, and I can see Darren McBrain off to the side and he's interviewing somebody. And there's like 10 people right here with a Hillary for Prison t-shirt on. And then like, you know, 100 yards down the road, there's another group of like three or four and they're all sitting there talking. They've
you know what I'm proud of? I'm proud of in almost all the videos, even ones we don't shoot, but the Breitbart shoots and others do.
They're everywhere.
It's our listeners with a, you know, mass murderers agree gun control shirt works. I designed that shirt like 18, 19 years ago and we still sell it. And it says peasants love disarmed or our politicians love disarmed peasants, Infowars.com on the back. And it's our guys and gals that are actually in everybody's faces, not hatefully going, you're an idiot. The globalists are enslaving you.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. It's our people that have the courage. Because the other Trump folks are nice. They kind of hang back.
Yeah.
It's our people that go into the melee. I mean, I'm really proud of the Infowars.
And
I mean,
calmly fight with facts.
But you can see them when they walk. They have a different
swagger
to them. You can see these guys wearing their Infowars shirts. They got their head held high, their posture straight, their shoulders are out, their chest is barreled. And they're walking right through these lines of protesters like, like taking it like badge of honor, like when they're cussing at him, screw Trump, screw you, you're a racist. They're like just marching through there, you know, the peacock is what I always like to call it, peacocking or whatever. And they're just walking through there and they come out the other end. They're like, yeah.
Absolutely. Now, getting into Uber and Lyft, I mean, here it is. It's running. It's operating. It's doing great. It drives down DWIs massively. And, I mean, it's just changing the way everybody does everything.
But
and now they're banning it.
It's 10,000 jobs lost pretty much right now with that. There's 10,000 people in Austin who are either driving for Lyft or Uber or both. A lot of them
and,
doing
and
both.
Lyft and Uber are right saying, screw you, we're leaving. That's going to make them capitulate as taxpayers and people get mad.
Well, the city wanted to take a cut of their earnings. Mm-hmm. And that's another thing they have an issue with. They're like, no, this is our...
The city has the highest taxes in the state of Texas.
And the great thing criminals. About Uber and Lyft is one simple thing. When you move to a new city, Austin is the fastest growing city in America. When I moved here 2 years ago, there was about 800,000 people. There's over 2 million people here now. When you move to a new city, what's the easiest job you can pick up and get right away? That's doing Lyft and Uber. That's a couple grand a week you can be making, putting in your pocket while you're looking for another
job.
Well,
listen, if they had plenty of taxis, it wouldn't be as big an issue. They're horrible drivers. It's weird.
But then they never show up.
Yeah. They never show up.
And then they ask you, which way are you going? They go, oh, I'm not going that way. And then they won't even take you anyways. Like, well, oh, well, I'm going this way, so I'm picking up people who want to go the way I'm going. No, that's not your job. Your job is for me to give you money and you to take me to where I need to go.
Well, here was my issue.
It's third world. Because when I'm in England, they just go, no, we're double charging you to go to your hotel. And then all these foreigners agreed until one guy from England pulled and he goes, oh, it's a scam. I'll give you a ride. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Well, my issue with it, and this is where you see the politics playing, is that you have a corporation who wanted to come in and tell the city how they're going to run their city. So we obviously don't want corporations coming in and violating states' rights. However, we also know on the back end, the city wants the cut of that money. So it's just like...
I was about to go further, because the state issue would be the state house, though.
Yeah.
The city is just a subdivision of that, but I agree, it should be done at the state level.
Well, they're wanting it to be a national thing with Uber, like, we don't want your regulations.
Well, they want everybody
I agree.
To be-
Stay there. Back in 70 seconds, fourth hour, straight ahead, Infowars.com. I'm going into overdrive. I'm taking over my own show. David Knight's going to be quarterbacking with us. We're going to take your phone calls, okay? Stay there. Everybody stay here. All right, David Knight's going to start co-hosting with us in the next segment. I'm going to go to at least 20 after so I can talk to Manny and Alex and Bill and Greg and Darren and others that are patiently holding. Leanne McAdoo and Joe Biggs are riding shotgun with us. I want to finish up on the whole Lyft Uber point and this whole balance. And then I want to come back in the next segment, just go bam, bam, bam through these calls and hand the baton to David Knight. But again, it's the complexity. The Democratic Party, Rahm Emanuel's brother, the big producer, they're all heavily involved in Uber. Uber says they want to get rid of humans and bring a monopoly in of robots. So they're creating monopolies. Mm-hmm. Then you've got the local mob bosses that want a cut of this. And then all I care about is the fact that it ends up taking my right to more choices away. And it's always government getting in the way, claiming it's for my safety.
It's always that.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And that was the whole deal, is that the Uber, Lyft, they said it would be too expensive to operate here if they start having all of these regulations handed down, which is why taxis are so expensive, because they have to comply with all these regulations. So it's not a level playing field. But they say that it's for our safety because, you know, then we will know that there isn't some rapist or criminal in the Uber. But then there was an article that came out in the Statesman, I believe, that was showing how taxi cab drivers hadn't been given their they hadn't had proper a background check in a while, and some of them were
look
criminals.
It's impossible. They always claim it's for your safety. It's a load of manure.
It totally is, and that's the reason why businesses love doing businesses here in Texas, is because we don't have so many regulations. But like you said, Austin is just a whole different
there's nowhere to park downtown.
Right.
You need it. It's such an awesome thing to have to go out, have dinner, have a few drinks.
Well, this is a model for the rest of the world. There's big battles happening. Other cities are trying to ban it or banning it in Europe. But once people have a taste of something, it's like the internet. It's going to be hard to put back in the bottle.
I agree.
Yeah, I mean, I just think it's one of the greatest things out there to have, because it gives people jobs. It's an easy way to employ people. Mm-hmm. It's a good way to earn some income. It's a good way to get around, not have to worry about getting pulled over.
Right.
If you've had a couple drinks, all this stuff. I like it. I love it. I wish we had it back here.
You hit the nail on the head, though. It's not the cops themselves that just want the revenue. It's the bosses above it.
Yeah. Right.
But they don't like this. They're trying to get rid of it.
Jakari goes to these meetings all the time, and he was saying that it's all about, they want people in Austin to be using public transportation. They want to be making that money. Mm-hmm. It's all about the revenue.
Oh, yeah, the so-called rail. And it's because if you're in Europe, compact cities, rail doesn't work here. You have to drive to the point to get on the train.
Right, there aren't.
And the train beds are old, and they're always flipping trains. It's I mean, I would never put my kids on an Amtrak.
No.
Yeah. And it's like, it's not even convenient for people who do want to go downtown at night. It stops running. So you can't even take it downtown and then take it back.
It stops running like right at the time that people actually go out.
Yeah, it's just ridiculous.
So let me ask you this question in closing. We're going to come back and take calls. Joe, you've gone over this. So now it's just going to be outlawed when, or it's just not going to be here?
As of 5 a.m. this morning, Uber and Lyft are gone. You can no longer access it. Apparently, they're trying to negotiate with the city to see what they can figure out. But at the end of the day, it's all about revenue. Mm-hmm. Austin wants their money. They want to make money off of this. They're not getting the revenue that they got from DWIs as much as they were getting.
They want the drunk drivers out there.
Yeah, I mean, when they put out these ads, like, we want to stop DWIs in Austin. No, they don't.
By the way, that's why they admit that they don't ever even or hardly arrest illegals for drunk driving, because the illegals just walk.
Right. Yeah. When they're the ones that have completely gotten rid of all the parking downtown, you can't even find a parking spot. It was their city design.
Yeah, this is the smart city screw job.
And then they're like, well, wait, something.
It's meant to make you take buses. We innovate around it with technology, so they want to screw that over.
Right, exactly. They have to be in control, and it's the whole pay-to-play thing. And in the one respect, I think Uber is correct. And then in the other, it's, you know.
I've never had a bad experience in Lyft, but anytime I've been in a cab, it's like, am I going to die?
Right.
Because it's some of the craziest people who are on their phone. And it's just like, oh, no, 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 you know, and they're on their phone the whole time. And they're not even paying attention. They're texting and they're swerving around. And
they're like, hug him around.
And I'm sitting there like, why is this guy yelling? And why is he driving me? How does this guy have a job right now?
I got ran over my foot by a taxi, and the cop pointed his finger at me and told me I shouldn't have been standing there. Like, really? The guy drugged me under his car.
We'll be back, Leanne. You racist? We're here in the war room right now. And we're going to be taking some of your phone calls here with Leanne McAdoo and Joe Biggs. Tell us, once we punch out of here in about 12 minutes, David Knight, what you've got lined up to cover, my friend.
Well, Alex, we're going to take a look at Venezuela, because the solutions that are being proposed there pretty much mirror what Obama, Hillary, and Bernie want to do in the U.S., and they're not working. They are headed towards disaster. It's the same policies we see here. Also, we've got a story that I think has some broad implications when we look at what Obama wants to do in terms of now discovering new rights for felons if you want to rent your apartment or your home. We now have a story out of Seattle, an 80-year-old great-grandmother who defended her family as a intruder broke into the house, stabbed her husband. She shot him dead. So we're going to talk about that, the implications of this new protected class. And, of course, there's some new protected class information coming out of North Carolina. That war is escalating as Obama discovers yet another new protected class, always about discrimination, and what's happening with the gay KK in North Carolina.
All right, powerful info. We're going to go to calls right now, but I haven't gotten into this whole quote, don't discriminate against felons. That includes child molesters, you name it. The Democrats, just like the Republicans, but Democrats more than anybody, are the ones that locked everybody up. They're the ones that passed minimum sentencing. And then they sit there as the saviors, saying, now we're just going to not let you discriminate against somebody who's a convicted felon.
Well, that's the only way Hillary can become the president.
Exactly. Well, they make everybody criminals, and then they become the client managers of the criminals and then represent them. Mm-hmm. This is what they do. They make you dependent. Just at every level, they want you institutionalized. Who's been holding the longest here? Let's go to Darren in the great state of Texas. Now under FEMA Region 6 occupation, literally. That's not for fun, folks. We're under FEMA provisional government, trying to get out from under it. Donald Trump says he wants to be a nationalist. That's why people that have hijacked the country freak out and say, no, we took it over. Well, not without a fight. But Darren, thanks for holding. You're on the air with Leanne McAdoo, Joe Biggs. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, my brother from another mother. Man, you guys are doing a great job there.
Thank you.
Listen, I think we need to get back to the spirit of the Constitution, like you guys say. Instead of just the restoration of the letters of the Constitution. You know, I want liberty. I want it now, both physical liberty, emotional, financial, and most important, spiritual. You know? And also, Dr. Tony Bart. Man, when you get her on again, talk about, I think y'all were starting to get into it when she was on, but the defense against, we're up against energy attacks, frequencies, these things. I know you know all this.
Oh, well, they admit, the birds are deformed that are by the big cell towers.
Yeah.
But just, we're all in a giant experiment right now. I mean, is crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she had information about that I would really love to find out.
Oh, we're
going to
get her back. Everybody loved her. I loved her. I instantly clicked with her.
And then, last point, if Anthony Gucciardi and Dr. Gru could work on a list of neuropathic doctors, I want to get away from the ND tyranny that's going on.
No, I hear you. I hear you. Well, it's, I mean, for me, it's a mix, but I hear you. There are a lot of good MDs that know what's going on. It's just that on top, it's orchestrated by Big Pharma and others. Thank you, Darren. Great points. Any comments, what he said?
Oh, I agree, especially with the electronic frequencies and stuff. Just like you were talking the article earlier about how just screens in general are affecting the way we think. Well,
in a bad way.
What about all the cell towers and just constant?
What's crazy is in every metric and study, it's all bad.
Right.
None of this is good.
Well, there's a new movie coming out. I think it's called Cell with Samuel L. Jackson. And they hijack the cell phone frequencies and turn everyone into zombies. it's this movie that's coming out.
Looks the really Kingsman, the same deal. But I remember in... If somebody could find this, I covered it like 20 times on air and then lost the printout article. It was in the Baltimore Sun, like 1999, maybe 2000. And it was DARPA going, we're practicing putting waves out through the cell tower carrier to calm you.
Right.
And it's like Fox Newscast going, actually, fluoride does help calm you. And now we want to put lithium in the water. People hear me say that and they don't believe it. You can go pull up the Fox News saying government wants to put lithium in the water. But I can't find the article where they admitted they're using cell towers. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I mean, that's what they're going to do to just placate the masses who want to vote for Donald Trump. They're going to put lithium in the water. It just and people say, well,
but I mean, they're actually saying it.
Yeah. Well, that's they try to tell libertarians, you know, you guys are so stupid. We need the government to protect the food, the water, the health. This, and you're like, what?
The government's a bunch of multinational corporations that took the country over.
We've all got a bunch of transmitters we keep in our pocket on us every day. Yeah. It's just like radiating.
Oh, when I tell people 20 years ago, your cell phone's tracking, it was federal law. Federal law since like 1998, it's all triangulated and people's going, oh, it's not.
I mean, if you download, like half these apps say, do you grant permission for me to gain access to your photos, right. your camera, your microphone, all of that. And people just go, yep. They don't ever read anything. And here
Roger Stone had to get all new computers because he'd come in and there'd be cursors clicking and things and downloading his data. He's like, what the hell?
Right.
And then people are like, oh, he's a conspiracy. They had news articles going, Stone claims his computer got hacked. No, Donald Trump's former campaign head, quarterbacking the resistance. No, no one's breaking into his computer.
Exactly.
Oh, no, that's so kooky. Oh, no.
Well, I remember when I
had to admit that they did it to Cheryl Atkinson, who had the video.
Well, of course they're breaking into Donald Trump's brain.
I remember when I first started working here, Darren McBreen told me the story where his cell phone, he would sit it down, it would turn on and flip through the different names. It would go to like Alex, Leanne. You know,
I've had to get rid of cell phones over and over again because once they hack it, I just smash it and have to get a new one. And they'll be dialing people and visiting websites I'm not going to. I mean, just like typing and calling people.
When I was in Pennsylvania, when I was interviewing Michael Strange's father, Charlie, the guy, the SEAL that died in Extortion 17, he was telling me stories with his wife is using a computer and all of a sudden, there's no webcam, but all of a sudden her on the computer screen's popping up on the monitor and they screenshot it.
That's because they've got patents where they inside. Can actually off the screen get video now.
Yeah. Wow. And they were telling me these stories and quite frankly,
they do that to mess with you.
Yo, they were scared because there was messages coming up. Stop looking into this. You know, why do you care about this? Stop.
Oh my God.
You know, like all this stuff. And they're like freaking out.
Because they knew the SEALs had credibility, but that's just like, finally they had the SEALs go on Fox News and say, she's a liar. And then nothing happened. I mean, she gave the order. Of course she gave the order. 13 hours, 8 hour stand down.
Right.
I mean.
And then she went to bed.
Oh, I mean, look, she gave the order. I'm exhausted. She's a freaking monster, man. I so many cynics go, hey, doesn't matter if Hillary wins. You're going to do a lot better on radio. You'll be so popular. She's going to probably try to have us arrested.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to be bigger because the new order gets bigger and everything I say comes true. I'm ready to dial this baby back. I don't want to have to literally work 18 hours a day.
No, I see her, if she becomes president, I really see bad things. I mean, just we're seeing that the government is already trying to up the
look what's happening in Europe.
New media.
Look what's happening in Europe. She comes in here, that's ushering in, right? That's going to be a train. High rate of speed coming in. No borders, everything. Everyone come in. Come on, let's all...
What do you make of Kerry coming out and saying no borders?
That's just completely...
And then the EU basically tells the UK, this will cause war if you leave. Because they'll start a war. This is world government, folks.
It's basically a warning. It's not a, you know, they're really bad.
But I mean, notice, they're under EU control. They didn't vote to join it, and now they can't leave.
I think everybody who doesn't want borders, you should go ahead and take your doors off your cars. You should take doors off your houses and just let everybody in. Let's just all... you know, one big commune.
Well, that's one blind spot America has, that we have the least level of holding passports except for like North Korea. Something like 70% of people never leave the U.S. They don't know how bad other parts of the world are.
Yeah. When I was in Molenbeek, Belgium, you get to see how bad it is. I got off the train where that incident happened not too long ago, the terrorist attack there. We got off the train. The first thing I saw was a guy with his pants down taking a dump on the sidewalk. That was the first thing I saw when I got there. Followed by a whole bunch of guys wanting to chase me out of there and basically cut my head off. You know, right. ISIS flags in the window.
And then you get to hear Trump being criticized. There's no no-go zones.
Yeah.
There's no. They're not beating up that reporter. The Muslims love us.
Yeah, they're not.
They freaking put women in slave dungeons with beekeeper hats.
Right.
And I mean, I told the story. We're going to skip the break. We're going to skip the break to give David more time. Again, I grew up around wealthy Muslims, smart people whose daughters were, you know, able to be free and they were intellectual. They're bringing all these poor Wahhabists now. I was at Barton Creek Mall with my daughters and my son and went to dinner and we were going to go see Captain America, which I walked out of, by the way. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, I turn a corner. There's women in full
burkas.
And it's everywhere. And then there's like these wild-eyed, crazy-looking guys like right out of Saudi Arabia running around. And it's like, my God, this is literally like a bazaar in Syria or something that's been overtaken by ISIS. And it was just so freaky. And then they were all looking crazy at my daughters with their blonde hair and everything. And just like, it was just freaky because, I mean, these are literal slaves. You're like seeing black people with chains around their necks or something. These women are slaves, not allowed to drive cars.
Right.
And it just totally freaked me out. Like, my whole life has been about honoring women and being, you know, truly a patriot. And then I'm seeing people that are literally taking over.
It's hijacked put my daughter by in slave so many dungeon. People who hate America.
There was an article.
You talk about being triggered, Leanne. I literally got nauseous.
No,
they were like everywhere. I was like, what the? I mean, you know.
Yeah. No, I've
the seen. Numbers they brought in are much higher. I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead, Leanne.
Yeah. Sorry. Well, there was actually a topic of discussion on the BBC. Should we allow Muslim women to drive more than 48 miles without a chaperone? I mean, this isn't a Western country. They are now saying
the buses now say Allah, you praise Allah, and the mayor's right. Muslim, and he says we've got to get more hardcore and not have Uncle Tom's. We got to push jihad.
They're importing people who don't want to assimilate to our ways whatsoever. I mean, right. You have
well, listen, like they can have
they
their
can cut
ways.
Someone's head off, and it's okay. But do you want to bring those people here?
Right.
I mean, in Germany, they tell. Remember the mayor, the liberal mayor of what was the big city, Cologne or whatever.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Said, listen, it's your fault, ladies. Don't dress sexy. You get raped.
Right. Dye your hair. Yeah. Don't look so blonde.
So the feminist says, watch how you dress. Leanne, how dare you be in a 50s, really like your style, by the way, today. I mean, how dare Leanne?
I know.
Just put it away.
Well, all the work.
Get rid of the goddess energy. Just hide that. Let's put a hood over your head it so can't. Some pot-bellied piece of filth can... Right. I just can't handle it.
All the work feminists in the West have done to get rid of that, you know, victim blaming and the this, and it doesn't matter what I wear. And then now they're injecting that language back into the country.
I know why the Germans, who put up with everything, are going and starting to beat these gangs up that have been raping women. I mean, I'm here to tell you, man, downtown Austin looks like Islamabad part of the time now. And I'm getting tired of it, okay? And I'm not going to sit here and put up with this. Bringing in a culture that has slavery going on of women. That's what it is.
Okay. Yeah, and then there's these communist marches going on everywhere now, like on Rainy Street on the weekends. Last weekend, I'm sitting outside having a drink, watching some hockey, and all of a sudden, all these communists with these flags or whatever.
Bitching with their smartphones, and wealth everywhere, lazy, dumb blobs waving their commie flags.
And they're like, you guys took the street, Rainy Street used to belong to poor Mexicans. This is part of Azalan, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, well, guess what? You lost a war, you lose the land, get over it, move on, assimilate.
But the truth is, Rainy Street, I had friends that lived over there. It was just a blue-collar and white-collar area of just houses and buildings, and a lot of them rotting and falling apart, you know.
That's where the old brothels were back in the day. Used to have the Western shootouts there and stuff.
But the point is, it wasn't Azadlan.
It was like...
Anybody can walk into those restaurants and places. It was Mexicans and Hispanics everywhere having a great time.
The whole earth
still tons of them there
Pangea,
now that go hang out. No one seems to care. It's just these commies. I've never seen so many communists in my entire life. Like, I thought this was over.
Look, they've been breeding it forever, saying it didn't exist.
God almighty.
Well, and that's the thing, too, with you have all these kids coming out with all this communist stuff, thinking that they're so original and they have all these original ideas, not realizing that the media, the social media, the schooling has just been programming them for decades, and they all think that they're so original.
Leanne, I just thought of a stunt we can pull. We should do some whole deal where you go, I want to be inclusive. And just like mother and father hurt someone that doesn't have a mother and father, he or she hurt someone that isn't he or she, I want to wear a burqa and just show like your life. You go to the grocery store, wear the hood over your head, a full outfit.
Oh, I've got my man jammies.
Like, what are you doing on air talking?
Oppressed right now.
What are you doing, lady? Women don't talk.
I got a...
Shut up. That's liberal.
I bought a pair of man jammies when I was in Dearborn, Michigan.
a chaperone with me to drive me there.
Oh, right, I'll take a few more calls
with you because I got
David
the beard.
Evan Knight, we're skipping the break here. I'm about to take a few more calls and turn it over to you. But what do you make of this whole rant here? I mean, you get the fact that I see these women with full deals on, not just, you know, with their eyes covered, but I mean the full hoods. And then it was like I turned this corner, I turned that corner, and I was just. And the men are all kind of gangster
and
thug
in
their own
like
groups,
crazy.
All enjoying themselves. And the women are wearing hoods over their heads. I mean, I'm freaking in the Jim Jones cult here. Am I wrong? Am I wrong?
My wife and I heard what you said about that over the weekend, Alex, and we both immediately said that's a spot-on analogy when you said, what if they were dragging people around here with chains on their necks because they believe in slavery? And that's precisely what it is. I thought that was a spot-on analogy. Why are we putting up with this? Why are we allowing this to overrun our culture? And, of course, some of the news that I'm going to talk about here, we see that Obama and the rest of them are openly plotting to replace us. I mean, we think giving better welfare benefits to people who are not American citizens.
The refugees get more than a social security person a year.
Right, exactly.
Yes. And it's also welfare. It's also in-state college tuition.
And they're not even thankful for it.
That's right.
They bring in Syrian refugees, give them houses. Meanwhile, we have homeless veterans sleeping under bridges in Austin.
Right.
All over the country.
Because we put up with it. I'm telling you, David, we're going to go to these calls here. Alex in Washington, thanks for holding on the air worldwide.
Yes, how you doing, Alex?
Good, go ahead.
Yes, sir. I wanted to call about General Dunford. I've heard some things about him lately, about he's the new chief of staff or whatever, former commandant of the Marine Corps. I actually served under him back in 97 when he was in Lejeune as a battalion commander. He was a lieutenant colonel back then. He's a really good man. I don't know much about him because I haven't really followed him, but I heard about him lately. Supposedly he's took over the Federal Reserve, shut it down, and maybe went to the White House, and he's got the army behind him or something.
Well, I always hear stuff like this. This general's going to do this. That general's going to do this. But I know this. I knew about it at the time, and then I was told by sources, and it turned out to all be accurate. Cy Hirsch reported on it. The U.S. Army, particularly 4.5 years ago, said, we're not backing Al-Qaeda. We're not going to do this. We're going to give the Russians the intelligence, and you can do whatever you want. You can fire us. Dempsey went in and met with Obama. And so that's why they had a big purge after that of trying to get people in place that will back the Saudi Arabian Jihad force. And then their side deal is they allow them to start taking over Europe. They've made a deal with Saudi Arabia in all of this.
Wow.
So I know that Dunford has come out and criticized Obama on women in frontline combat. So the Marine Corps is kind of resisting more. I would always poo-poo saying there's good folks at the highest levels of the military, and they're saying no because I've never seen evidence of it. We are now seeing evidence of that. And it's very, very historic, but I would expect to see more. I mean, we're dealing with open, naked tyranny, Alex.
Oh, for sure. I mean, I'm pretty sure he's a good man. I mean, he humped us 26 miles, I don't know how many times. Never seen a guy do 26-mile hump, gather his officers, and then go run 5 miles with a pack afterwards. It's like, I'm pretty sure he's a good man, and I think if you could really follow him a little closely, a little more closer, because I've heard some other things that they shut the Federal Reserve down. It's not .org anymore. It's .gov now, and they're printing U.S. dollars.
No, I hear you. Let me throw this in. Even people that aren't perfect, when you get down to the point of gutting the country and breaking it forever and outlawing families and forcibly inoculating everybody, you come to a moment where you realize the globalists are going to screw me over. Why should I go along with them?
Right.
Why should I go along with the fads of the mainstream media? Why should I buy into these cosmologies? Why should I do this? And you realize it's a delusion to think you can join with this system. Maybe 50 years ago, if you sold out your culture, you'd be rich and powerful now, but you're not. There's not enough slots in the New World Order. Mm-hmm. It is a system that's based on the reverse of prosperity. You guys want to comment? I'm going to throw the baton here.
Like you see in all the movies when the elite are getting in their ships to go to space or whatever far off planet, and there's never enough room. And the people who think, they're like, oh, well, I've been doing all your dirty work all these years, let me on. And they shut the door in their face. And that's how it's going to be.
Well, traitors always get taken out even faster than the patriots. Once evil takes over, right, the first thing it does is take out its minions.
Right.
Because they know where the bodies are buried. This is such a dishonorable system. We're going to go to break. Thank you, Alex. And if callers want to hold, I'm not sure. David, you want to take calls? I know you got a bunch of news to cover.
Sure. Yeah, I'll take calls.
All right. Well, cover your news and then go to the folks. They can hold. I appreciate them calling Mark and Greg and Bill and Robert and others. Toll-free number is 800-259-9231. Briefly, you mentioned Hillary for prison shirts. We had the limited edition. I followed, you know, my pledge and stopped having it. People got so upset. We brought back a new limited edition that's similar, but a new limited edition of Hillary for President. Great way to promote solidarity. Great way as we go into the main election to expose what a criminal this woman is and to be on the news with it at Trump rallies, Hillary rallies. You're having a phenomenon. InfoWars is showing the power of the InfoWarriors. Bolon Labe shirts are everywhere as well, and you're funding our operation. It has 4.9 stars out of 191 reviews. InfoWarsStore.com. Also, we cannot offer the 30 to 40% off on the high-quality storable food anymore, but with the four top-selling products, the four top-selling packages, the 4 weeks, the 6 months, it goes on to a year, the highest quality out there at the lowest price, great packaging, very fresh. It's what I've chosen for my family. You can get 40% off. I've been authorized to run this for 1 week, but on the 4 week supply, the 3 month supply, the 6 month supply, the 1 year supply, that is running right now. And they say 30 to 40 on this. I guess that's some algorithm or something with the deals, but I told them 40%, but I guess I'm not allowed to do that. The point is, it's as good as the other deal, but I can't do it on the entire, because they got special meals and a lot of other packages, over 60 different configurations. But on these four top best sellers, we got 30 to 40% off running at InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. The nutraceuticals, it all ends tonight. 10% off on all the nutraceuticals as part of preparedness, the non-GMO seeds, the water filtration systems, the crank radios, shortwave radios, solar-powered systems. Just everything is preparedness. Hundreds of items, G-Shock watches, optics, InfoWarsStore.com, the great car battery charger systems that run off all these different devices and jumpstart your car. It's like the size of like a third of a briefcase. It's just amazing what technology is doing. We need to be self-sufficient. And know this, your purchase of the products funds the very tip of the spear in the fight for human liberty. We are looking for the truth. We're taking action. We're defending the human family. We are having huge effects across the world, showing that a resistance can be put up against the tyrants. And your funding of the operation is essential. But just spread the word about our videos, our articles. Post our stuff on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube. Repost our videos. Tell your email list, your friends, your family, your neighbors. This is a war, and say there's a fight. Do you know? The modern Paul Revere's are here. InfoWars.com. We're part of it, too. And there's an excitement, and it's there. And criminal elites always think they're invincible. But history shows time and time again they're not when the human spirit of liberty is ignited. Leanne, 20 seconds. Joe Biggs, 20 seconds. We're going to go to break. Come back with David Knight.
Well, that's very powerful stuff. I think even if they do manage to take down the internet, it's still not going to stop what we've already started.
So we got to start planting seeds right now.
InfoWars is so popular everywhere we go. It's so amazing when you go out. Everyone's coming up to us with all the nascent iodine X2 stuff to show us that they're getting it. They're supporting us. They're happy that they're supporting it. They're behind it. They love what you guys are doing. They love everything you do, Alex. It's amazing to see culture happen like this, sweeping across the country.
Absolutely. And again, these are great nutraceuticals, you name it, but it's also about a symbol.
We're on the march.
All right, we'll be back.
The Empire
Stay with
on
us.
The run.
David Knight, straight ahead.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host, and I'm going to go to these callers. I tell you what, Bill, I just noticed Bill in Indiana have been holding for a very long time, just dropped off. Bill, if you want to call back, we can take your call. I'm going to go also to Robert, to Greg, to Mark in Arizona. I'm going to take those calls. I do have some news that I want to cover before I go to those calls, so hang on just a little bit longer, guys, and I'll get to you. One of the things I want to talk about, because I think it's very important, we see Bernie Sanders and the massive movement of college students who don't know any better rallying behind Bernie the socialist. And we need to look at what these policies that Bernie has supported all of his life for 35 years, what have they done to Central America, for example, okay? We know that he went down and he was absolutely in love with the Sandinistas in Nicaragua. We've got the recordings of when he went back there and came back and he said, well, maybe I'm a dupe, but I think they're great, you know. And I was, yeah, he is a dupe. And he's duped a lot of people into this socialism that he's selling. But when you look at what they're trying to do in Venezuela as this country spirals down into the drain, okay, it mirrors precisely the solutions that we hear coming from Obama, from Hillary, not just from Bernie, okay? Let me give you an example. This is a story from WND. I think it was up on the Drudge Report. As Venezuela slides closer into the abyss, the country's socialist leaders have been trying everything to stop the tailspin. Now, the current president, you know, Hugo Chavez is dead, but he lives on in his policies, okay? They have raised fuel prices by more than 6,000%, and they're trying to conserve electricity by proclaiming holidays for public employees, telling women to stop using hair dryers. We've covered all this before, right? They got rapid inflation. They've raised the minimum wage. Okay, what are their solutions? The same stuff that we see from Obama and Hillary and Bernie. For example, this is a country, like America, that has more than enough natural resources to satisfy all of its energy needs. Okay, we have massive oil reserves here. We have massive coal reserves in the United States, but we're not going to be allowed to use them, just like Venezuela, if we have the Obama, Hillary, Bernie people in charge, the Democrats, the people who tell us, no, we got to go to green power. How'd that work out for Venezuela? They went to hydroelectric power. Guess what? They got a drought. Guess what? It's not very efficient. Guess what? They subsidize the electricity prices to an unrealistic level. Just like we're going to have Bernie and Hillary give everybody free this, free that, free college education, whatever. Okay? This is the way it always rolls. And they're going to make everybody in Venezuela feel better by giving them a minimum wage increase. I mean, this would be a joke if it wasn't so serious. This is precisely what the Democrats want to do to this country. What Hugo Chavez and Maduro have done to Venezuela. And then the title of the WorldNet Daily article was absolute genius. It was actually taken from a college professor and author of a book called Takedown from Communists to Progressives, How the Left Has Sabotaged Family and Marriage. Paul Kinger said this. He said, and now they're talking about in the context, what they're saying is they move the country's time zone by 30 minutes to try to save energy by getting different daylight hours. And he says, instead of the regime moving the country's time ahead by 30 minutes, they should be moving it forward into the horizon of free markets. Instead, they have looked back to the year 1848, the year of Karl Marx's Communist Manifesto, rather than to a future of economic freedom. That's just it. And of course, we got Bernie Sanders, who is a throwback to the Sandinistas. That's why I call him Bernie Sandernista, because he thinks that the problems were solved back when we had these wonderful guys. You know, they wrote poetry, he says. Look it up. It's absolutely amazing and hilarious, the speech he gave, especially when you look back with 2020 hindsight, yet Bernie hasn't learned a thing, and neither have his supporters. They don't want to figure out what happened in Nicaragua. Daniel Ortega that he praises, the Sandinistas that he praises, were nothing but a bunch of thugs and kleptocrats. They stole everything from everybody. And of course, they said, oh, it's for the public good, until they were being thrown out by not only the conservatives, but the liberals, the left and the right threw him out because he was nothing but a thief. And what he did was then he and his cabinet privatized some of the stuff that they had stolen, privatized it for themselves. And of course, they talk about the fact that they have fixed, listen to some of the metrics here. They fixed the official price of electricity in Venezuela as 3 cents per kilowatt hour for businesses. Now, other people, the unofficial rate is a half a cent for individuals. Now, in the United States, the average price is 10 cents a kilowatt hour. But, of course, they subsidize that there, just like Bernie and Hillary and Obama want to subsidize free college education at an unrealistic price. Guess what happens when you subsidize stuff at an unrealistic price? You wind up rationing it. You wind up losing it. And that's what's happening with just electricity. But, of course, we've reported on this multiple times. It was absolutely amazing that Bloomberg was bragging about Wall Street investors saying, hey, and this was 2014, early part of 2014. I've covered this many times. They said, look, we've got a 700% return on investment from Venezuela. This is great. Even though the people are having to go to adjacent countries in order to get food, medicine, water, they know they have to pay the bankers first. And so we're doing good, and we're going to keep doing business in Venezuela because, you know, socialism and communism is good for these bankers. That's why they financed Lenin to start the Russian Revolution. They sent him from Switzerland into Russia with $10 million in a train. And that was a German central banker, brother of the guy who helped establish our own Federal Reserve here in the United States. It's always been a good deal. Communism has always been a good deal for these guys. They love that. They love that. It fits perfectly like a hand in a glove. And guess who the Wall Street bankers are supporting here? Okay, the closest thing they got to Hugo Chavez, Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton is consolidating her support among Wall Street donors. This is reported by the Wall Street Journal. It's part of the Never Trump crowd, okay? But they're saying Wall Street donors and other businesses ahead of a general election battle with Donald Trump are consolidating their support behind Hillary Clinton. She has received 53% of the donations from Wall Street in March. Now, this is even before everything consolidated under Trump, okay, before he got the nomination. I'm sure they were still throwing a lot of money Ted Cruz's way back in March. They say that was up from 32% last year and up from 33% in January through February. Now, what's happened? They used to give a lot of their money to people like Jeb Bush and Marco Rubio. But now that those guys, after they crashed and burned, they gave some money to Ted Cruz, but a lot of the Bush and Rubio supporters start coalescing behind Mrs. Clinton. Because why? Because socialism works out great for Wall Street. They are not polar opposites, folks. They are business partners, just like they are in Nicaragua, just like they are in Venezuela. Wall Street loves socialism. It pays really well for them. 700% return on investment in Venezuela. And look at what's happening to the people there. And look at the solutions that are being put out there by the socialists. Minimum wage increase, rationing, and green energy. That's going to pull them out. Yeah, just like Hillary Clinton is going to take all the, shut down all the coal mines, take all the jobs. But don't worry, because they're going to have some kind of green energy that they're going to offer them. Let's go to your phone calls now. Let's go to Greg in Ohio. Greg, go ahead. Thanks for holding, Greg. Thanks for holding such a long time. Go ahead.
All right, no problem. Well, you helped prove the point I called in on. Firstly, I'd like to say I'm a daily listener and a Prison Planet subscriber and a proud owner of an Alexa Pure water filter. Love the water it puts out in.
Oh, thank you.
X2 and Secret 12 are great products.
I just ordered my Alexa Pure, so I'm anxious to. It's on its way, so I'm anxious to try that as well.
Love it.
Yeah, that's great.
My wife had a had very low B12 levels before she started taking Secret 12, and after about 3 months, she got her blood tested again, and she's got like at the top range now for her B12 levels.
Wow.
After taking Secret 12, so we love that.
Yeah, I got to say I'm happy that happened, but I'm not surprised. This is the real stuff. And Alex and goes to a great deal of effort to make sure that he has top quality stuff that's very pure. And I'm not surprised to see that. And as he's mentioned, he wanted to have this product because he himself had to take injections to get his B12 levels up. And so it's very, very effective. I'm glad to hear that's working for you.
Yeah. Well, I also wanted to shout out to Biggs because when he was up in Detroit area where I live, doing the Dearborn Mosque interview, I was one of three guys who came down to support him and kind of get his back to make sure that, you know, he didn't get anybody hassling him while he was there. So I got my picture taken with Joe and put it on my Facebook page, so I'm pretty proud of that.
That's great. Thanks for having our back.
Sure. The reason I called, you made my case. I've been on hold for like an hour and a quarter.
I know.
And I'm driving back from my mom's in North Carolina back to Detroit. And during my trip last week and today, I've been kind of surfing the radio, listening to some. I want to get some education, so I thought I'd listen to some progressive radio, and I tapped into a couple on Sirius XM. And after trying to keep my head from exploding after listening, I thought, well, I'm going to call in and rebut what they have to say and engage them in conversation. And I got on within 2 minutes of making the call in both of those shows, which tells me that the liberal talk radio is just dying.
Yeah.
Because Breitbart, you might take a week to get on Breitbart even.
That's
if
right.
You're lucky. But I think that InfoWarriors could do a lot of good just by calling those shows and having dialogue with them. You know, don't get on to yell because that doesn't do any good. They'll out-yell us. But we might be able to make a point, you know, that may help our cause.
Well, that's right. And if they get upset, just stay calm and keep coming at them with the facts. I mean, that's a great thing to do. It is absolutely amazing to hear progressive radio. I was listening to it the other day, and they started talking about this polio vaccine situation where they're replacing the worldwide supply, and they have 2 weeks to replace everything in the world, and they want it buried or burned, and they're very adamant about that. And as they were talking, the one lady who was the host there said, well, of course, nobody gets it, gets polio from these vaccines. And the guy goes, oh, no, actually, they do. It's actually, it's metastasized here. It's mutated and... is the right word, not metastasized. But, of course, they do have cancer viruses. Nevertheless, he said it's mutated and people have actually gotten polio from this. So that's one of the reasons why we're changing it. I just about pulled off the side of the road when I heard that because, of course, they've always denied that you could get polio from these vaccines. They say, well, it's polio-like symptoms, but it's not really polio. You have to understand that. So it's truly amazing. Sometimes you hear some incredible stuff on the progressive radio. I didn't call in, though. But that's great. Thanks, Greg. I really appreciate you letting us know about that. Let's go to Mark in Arizona. Mark, you've been holding a long time as well. Thank you so much for holding. Go ahead.
How you doing, David?
Doing good.
Hey, if Alex is still listening, I just want to let him know it's great to see him smiling so much today. It makes me feel like things are changing for the better, and
yeah,
and it makes me keep the faith.
Oh, yeah. So, oh, yeah. I think there's a lot of people who are waking up. Yeah, I really do. Go ahead. Did we lose you, Mark? You know, go ahead. Are you there, Mark? Go ahead. Well, I think we lost him. One of the things I thought was interesting was in terms of people waking up, there was an article talking about Nancy Pelosi and Vicente Fox meeting together. And I thought it was pretty amazing what Vicente Fox, former president of Mexico, had to say. He spent a half hour with Nancy Pelosi. And they were kind of brainstorming as to how they could defeat Trump. Isn't that interesting? Head of state from a foreign country brainstorming with our former Speaker of the House, now the House Minority Leader, and they are working together, conspiring on how they can influence our election. And Vicente Fox said that he's becoming a big fan of Clinton. I'm sure he always has been. He compared her to Margaret Thatcher. I don't think so. And he disparaged Trump supporters as lazy, uneducated TV-watching drunks. Isn't that amazing? He thinks that we're not awake. He says we need to wake up that citizen, those Trump supporters who are lazy, uneducated TV-watching drunks. That's what he thinks of you if you support Donald Trump. You need to be woken up. He says, we need to take away from them the TV, the drinking and the beer, to working hard and to getting the skills, to getting knowledge, and they will come along like everybody else. Well, you know, here's part of the problem, Vicente. You know, you say that Mexico buys billions of dollars of items for the United States that create 10 million American jobs, but Trump supporters still don't respect us. You know what? I don't know where you got your statistics from, but the reality is that we have lost millions of jobs. We have a trade deficit with Mexico. Yeah, they may buy billions of dollars, but we buy tens of billions of dollars from Mexico. Since NAFTA, we have seen a trade deficit that used to be up 1 year for Mexico, up 1 year for U.S. That used to alternate back and forth, plus or minus $5 billion. As soon as we passed NAFTA, it shot up to $15 billion deficit, and it has continued to increase since then. We had a $60 billion deficit this last year. We've lost about $1 trillion to NAFTA in the 23 years that it's been in place. And that's one of the reasons maybe why some of these guys are watching TV and getting angry is because maybe they don't have jobs because their jobs have been sent to Mexico. And then he goes on to say this. What I've been saying here, I told her, count with us, count with all Mexicans to support the Democrat Party. So here we are. Mexicans, both inside our country and outside our country, foreign leaders are working with the Democrats to try to make sure that Donald Trump doesn't become president because they have to get rid of us. They have to replace us. That's along the lines of this story that we've mentioned a couple of times. Cashing in, illegal immigrants get $1,261 more welfare than American families. And, of course, we saw just last week it was a couple of $1,000 that young students get more than retirees who have paid 15% of their wages their entire working life. Now, people who just come into this country illegally get more money than somebody who is retiring on Social Security. And then, of course, there's the in-state tuition. If you come here as a dreamer, you can get in-state tuition in any of the states, but not if you paid taxes here. See, the whole point of in-state tuition was to try to give some relief to the families who had paid taxes in Texas or had paid taxes in Oklahoma, whatever state they lived in. They would get tuition relief there because they paid taxes. But these people come in and they get in-state tuition rates wherever they want to go, even though they have not paid taxes here, even though they have come here illegally flaunting our laws. You kind of get the idea that Obama wants to replace us. Let me go to Robert. I know he's been hanging on for a while, and we lost the other call. Sorry, Mark, in Arizona, we weren't able to get that back. Let's go to Robert in California. Go ahead, Robert.
Thanks, David. I've been listening. You were talking about it, and there is a huge awakening going on all over the country. And for the first time, we're really getting to see how popular the pro-America, pro-liberty movement and how popular it really is. And we got a little bit of a taste of it when Ron Paul was running in 2012, but you saw the media really come against him and the establishment Republican Party. But now with Donald Trump, we're really getting to see how popular that is, and there is a huge awakening. And to Vicente Fox, I don't watch TV.
Hang on, Robert. Hang on just a little bit longer. We're going to take a break, and we'll come right back, let you finish up that call. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Radio Show. I'm David Knight. We're going to go back to our caller, Robert, in California real quickly. I want to let you know that tonight, the 10% off all preparedness products at InfoWarsStore.com is going to be ending. That's 10% off all shortwave radios, heirloom seeds, water filters, watches, security products, and survival accessories. That will be ending tonight at midnight. That's 10% off all of those, as well as 10% off of all of our preparedness products at InfoWarsLife.com, all of our supplements that are there. You can get 10% off of preparedness products as well as supplements at InfoWarsLife.com. Also, we still have the sale that has been extended, 30 to 40% off all of our best-selling InfoWars Select Storable Foods. These are items that have a shelf life of 25 years. Right now, while they're 30 to 40% off, is the perfect time to stock up on these made-in-the-USA, GMO-free, high-quality foods in the best packaging you'll find. You can get that at InfoWarsStore.com. Let's go back to Robert in California. Robert, you were saying that you believe that people are waking up en masse to Donald Trump. I think we can see that in the numbers. The people who have voted, the people who are showing up in these crowds is absolutely unprecedented from what I've seen. And yet we have Vicente Fox saying, no, we're a bunch of drunks who are watching TV and totally asleep. Let me ask you real quickly, what do you think about the back and forth with Paul Ryan? I think that he's going to be the biggest obstacle that President Trump would have to getting the globalist policies repealed, putting America first. What do you think?
Well, I don't think Paul Ryan stands a chance against Donald Trump. I think the one message I would have for Trump, and I don't need to tell him this, obviously, is not to listen to any of the advice that he's getting from the mainstream media to, you know, temper his message or, you know, water down his politic, because clearly what he's saying and what he's doing is resonating with the American populace. And that's why he's winning in landslides, five states in a row, really shutting down the mainstream media, and the people are ready for that message. They've been ready, and they're so hungry for it. Everywhere I go, if I wear an InfoWars shirt or if I'm out there with a microphone asking people what they think of Donald Trump, if their friends aren't nearby, they're, you know, saying that Donald Trump's a great person, he's going to be the next president. Only the people that are watching all these sitcoms and being indoctrinated and have really been inoculated from an Americana-type president like Trump, that's what the whole message is on TV, and you see it in the news, but also in the sitcoms and all these comedy shows. They're demonizing anybody who speaks an Americana message. They're talking about, you know, conspiracy theorists, and people aren't buying it anymore. So real thing is that the people that are educated aren't listening to them, so it doesn't matter. And Vicente Fox, you know, his base, the people that he's speaking to are the ones that are watching TV and really being misinformed.
Well, I hope he keeps on with that, because I think that's really going to help to make a President Trump. I think it's going to be very interesting what happens between Donald Trump and Paul Ryan. That's what we really need to call him, Republican in name only, Paul Ryan, because, you know, he is the face of the GOP establishment. that repeatedly has campaigned to do things like repeal Obamacare, to get control of the borders, do all these other things, and has refused to do it. And so I think it's going to be very interesting. We've got the primary for Paul Ryan on August the 9th. And by that time, we should understand how this is going to break down between Donald Trump and Paul Ryan. I hope Paul Ryan hangs tough so we understand who the enemy is. Because if he tries to pretend that he's on the side of Donald Trump, and if Donald Trump buys it, he's going to find that Paul Ryan is going to be his biggest obstacle to getting anything that he says he wants to do done. So hopefully we're going to get him primaried out. This looks like a pretty good guy who's going to be running against him in Wisconsin. Well, that's it for our show today. Join us tonight at 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern for the Nightly News.